Everybody knows that Mike Vick is here. We know it. What do you think about this left-handed quarterback?
Well, I really don't know how to describe this guy. There's really no point of comparison in NFL history. Never in the history of this league has there been a point in time when the quarterback was the fastest player on the league, on the field. You go back to what he did last week against the Minnesota Vikings, 173 yards rushing, 173 yards passing, has one of the strongest arms playing in the National Football League today. And so there's a lot of talk about this guy potentially being the MVP of the league. And why not? But Troy, if you are going to be considered the best, you have to beat the best. And that is the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and this defense.
That's right. There's no question that he's a special player. And today we get to find out how well he can play in a big game in December in the NFL. One guy who does know how he can play is defensive coordinator Monty Kiffin for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, who spent a lot of long hours this week at the office trying to come up with plans as to how they can slow Vic down. What he has concluded is they're going to keep doing what they've doing. They've faced a lot of mobile quarterbacks already this season, Vic included. They've had success. The real key to me today is how well this Tampa Bay offense runs the football. It's been a running game pretty much by committee. Today, the guy who's going to get a lot of carries is Aaron Stecker, and if he's able to run the ball, then they're going to be able to take time off the clock and keep Mike Vick on the sidelines.
We ask our Sprint virtual coach question, and it is this. Who is the best runner in the NFL? Vote now using PCS Vision from Sprint or log on to foxsports.com. Why is this a big game for Tampa? Well, unlike other years, they've gotten off to a good start this season. But it doesn't mean much if they don't finish strong. They could go from a number two seed in the NFC today. With a loss, they could be the number six seed. You know they want to play in warm weather when the playoffs roll in. A big test for Mike Vick. He'll try to carve up that outstanding Tampa Bay defense. You know the defense is ready for him. Should be a good matchup, and it's yours next on Fox.
You're watching the NFL on Fox.
Come on, we got a show, people. We got a show.
The designers at Chrysler invite you to preview our holiday collection. A national event featuring 0% financing for 60 months on most of our collection of stylish head-turning minivans. Or generous cash allowances up to $3,500. In addition, you'll receive a leather trim seating credit on select models. So consider this your invitation and see your Chrysler dealer today.
Sam, I'm at the airport.
Hey, welcome back, pal.
You remember that conversation we had?
I sure do, buddy. Which conversation was that?
The one where I said I don't do any ads.
No ads. I really got to start writing things down.
Sam, that's the only one, right?
Absolutely. That's it. It was a one-shot deal.
Sam.
There might be one or two buses. Maybe.
It only happens once a year. Toyotathon 03. This year-end tradition features the awe-inspiring all-new 2003 4Runner. It's larger, more powerful. And now with great Toyotathon deals, you can get more SUV for your money. Only your Toyota dealers have the quality, selection, and values you've waited for all year. Toyotathon 03. Don't miss it.
After Fox's coverage of today's game, stay tuned for Chip Carter's Bucs postgame show with highlights, interviews, and expert analysis, all right here on Fox 13. Fox Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the National Football League.
Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why you had to hide away for so long. Where did we go wrong? Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why you had to hide away for so long. Where did we go wrong? Hey there, Mr. Blue Sky, look around, see what you do. Everybody
Play of the Week is brought to you by Microsoft, providing software to help businesses be more agile. Despite the snowy conditions, Buffalo quarterback Drew Bledsoe was able to connect with receiver Fearless Price, who faked out Miami's Arturo Freeman and sped into the end zone.
Down to the 40, a foot race, 30, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown, Fearless Price, they did it!
Price's speed helped him outrun the Miami defense.
What a tremendous play!
Gina? You know, when I was first hired, we didn't have all these fancy integrated systems. Our sales program wasn't even linked with accounting. Warehouse platform in Chicago wasn't linked to anything, not even shipping. Back then, orders took days. Now, they just take hours.
Wow, how long have you been working here?
A couple of months now.
Oh.
With Microsoft Server software, you can quickly connect all aspects of your business. That's software for the agile business. From Microsoft.
Along with our director, Artie Kempner, and our producer, Richie Zients, there's Mike Vick. Last second encouragement. The Falcons won the toss they receive, and here's last second encouragement and instruction from Monty Kiffin, the defensive coordinator for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Thought it was interesting that Monty Kiffin was up front by the fact that with Gruden down here, Gruden's not only trying to turn around this offense, but with the way he's talked to the defense and challenged them, he's really given life to the defense, which for years has been good here in Tampa.
Well, I think what's happened is John Gruden has come in and he's held this offense to the same standard that this defense has been held to for several years under Monty Kiffin. And I think not only Monty Kiffin, but these defensive players certainly respect that.
You just want to watch the kick, Chris?
I can't wait to see Mike Vick.
Line drive kick from Martin Gramatica, and Alan Rossum, the former Packer, from about a yard deep in the end zone, will get to the 20, cross it, and he is knocked down at the 23. Well, the last seven games since coming back from the injury he suffered in the Tampa Bay game back in Atlanta, seven rushing touchdowns, six passing touchdowns, and the record that Troy circles, 6-0-1. The Falcons are unbeaten in their last eight. And we have to talk like we're doing a hockey game because of that tie against the Pittsburgh Steelers.
But you know, this is a team that's really come a long way back. They started the year 1-3 and nobody took them seriously at all.
The rest of the division got out to a hot start, but now it's the Falcons that are the hottest team in the NFC. What do they have in store for the Buccaneers? A handoff to Bobby Christian, who got a yard.
Number 34, Bob Christian, the ball carrier.
Up front, protecting Mike Vick. Bob Whitfield telling us, we just can't get this guy killed. That's pretty much how they go into the game. And their right tackle, with a left-handed quarterback protecting the blind side, is a good one. A guy they got from Seattle, Todd Weiner, a young player, but they like what he's giving them. Warrick Dunn, the former Buccaneer, in the backfield, with Christian blocking for him. And the wide receivers do not have a ton of speed. TJ Duckett in the backfield now for Atlanta. A quick setup, the throw, and it's incomplete. Finneran, the intended receiver. And this defense will line it up and come after Mike Vick on third and long. Up front, they are the best front four around the NFL. And they get Anthony McFarland back. That's a big help in the middle for Warren Sapp. The linebackers, Derek Brooks, best weak side linebacker in the business. And the safeties, Lynch and Jackson. There's McFarland. Third and eight. Vick gonna run. Penalty flag, and Vick is smacked. Derek Brooks.
Holding. Offense, number 71. The penalty is declined. Fourth out.
Three and out with an exclamation point at the end of it.
Well, the Buccaneers on defense are so good on the outside with Simeon Rice and Warren Sapp. That means that Vick's going to run the ball. He's going to have to run it up the middle. And Derek Brooks, on the first opportunity, drills Michael Vick.
Chris Moore will give us the first punt of the day with Carl Williams waiting deep. high-hanging, spiraling punt, and Williams will let it bounce. And it rolls all the way down inside the 25-yard line. It'll be tapped at the 23. Brad Johnson at quarterback for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Look at this season compared to last season, and I think, truth be told, he has shocked John Gruden with how well he has handled this offense, and they have really heaped a lot on the back and the right shoulder of the veteran quarterback Johnson.
Well, there's no denying the fact that if Brad Johnson was not playing at the level that he's playing at, this team would not be where they're at. They have no running game to speak of. That has to change today if they're going to have any kind of success moving the football and putting points on the board.
Shifting before the first snap on offense for the Buccaneers and play action. Johnson over the middle, hits his running back Pittman, and a gain of only two on the play. That's really the way they use their running game. They almost use the short passing game like a running game because they have struggled so much in the reason this group. The offensive line anchored by Jeff Christie in the middle, but the offensive line has been a major disappointment for the Buccaneers this season. Pittman and Allstott in the backfield, but as Troy said, we'll see a lot of Aaron Stecker today with Keyshawn Johnson at one wide receiver position, Keenan McCardell at the other, 11 catches last week. Second and eight. And Johnson falls as he drops back. Kearney ends up on top of him, third and long coming up. Guys, I apologize for the 12th week in a row. I just have to keep talking. It's the way they make me do this.
You're doing a good job.
Thanks. It's a 3-4 defense with Ed Jasper in the middle. See a lot of Ellis Johnson on passing downs. We might see him here on third and long. The linebackers, Stewart, Draft, Brooking, and Rogers in the secondary. They try to get by with McBurrows and Carpenter as their safeties. Wade Phillips is the defensive coordinator. Third and 13. Johnson throws to an open spot in the field, and Johnson with big pressure on him. Ellis Johnson, who was in on third and long, ends up on top of Brad Johnson.
And one of the major stories today is Ray Buchanan, who's the best man-to-man cover man for the Atlanta Falcons, is out there playing with an abdomen strain that is absolutely killing him. He's got it shot up before the game. I watched him on that play in man coverage. He cannot run. I'm sure the coaches in the press box for the Bucs right now are saying, we have to go after him and go after him early.
That's if they can provide protection for Brad Johnson. And it wasn't there on that first series.
They go.
Awful punt by Tupa. On a hop, that's Allen Rossum, and nothing on the return. So not a good punt, not a pretty punt, but in a way effective. Net of 38 yards. Dwight Smith on the tackle, and Vick and company back to work.
Right now, fly Southwest Airlines for just $39 to $99 each way when you purchase by December 12th. So get packing.
You are now free to move about the country.
Honey, I'm stuck in North America. Could you write this down, please? You go south through Canada.
Need a lot of minutes? Switch to Sprint, and for just $30 a month, get unlimited night and weekend minutes and 300 anytime minutes. And get a free PCS phone instantly at Sprint stores.
Boy, that was embarrassing.
It never happened.
PCS from Sprint. Clearly, the phone to give or get.
First reconfigurable luxury SUT. Cadillac Escalade EXT. Breakthrough.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Southwest Airlines, proud sponsor of the NFL and official airline of Super Bowl 37.
Dan Reeves and the Falcons on offense telling us yesterday that they're going to try to take some shots down the field to open things up a bit. They certainly didn't do that the first possession. The winningest coach among the active coaches around the NFL. And there's Simeon Rice, who was the defensive player of the month for the month of November. A lot of attention paid to number 97 for the Buccaneers. Starting at their own 42. Play action, and Vick looking for somewhere to throw it. Now he'll try to run. Gets one. Derek Brooks on the stop. Isn't the key, Chris Collinsworth, for these defenders for Tampa Bay to stay in their lanes and not try to do too much?
Well, you're going to see Simeon Rice. He takes an inside path right here. He's a defensive end, and they were told all week long, stay up the field. Do not let Michael Vick outside of the pocket. But that's what happened. Then you see Derek Brooks, number 55, who's another guy who's having an outstanding season this year, makes the play on the backside.
Second down and nine. And a handoff is to Duckett. He gets to the 45 and just beyond. Greg Spires made the tackle. A gain of a couple. Third down coming up again.
The thing that's going to make it so difficult for Mike Vick today, and you saw on that first play when they bootleg this way, they put a tight end on Simeon Rice's side. But think about trying to move to your left as a left-handed passer. Most of the damage that Vick does is to the left side. You've got to get through Simeon Rice and Warren Sapp, probably the two best that there is right now in the National Football League, and both on the same side of the field.
Don't forget about Brooks.
Not bad either.
Vick throws, and he has his first completion. Ripped out of bounds is Jefferson, and they mark him just shy of first down yardage.
And it's a shame when you run the route and you run it properly and the ball's thrown and you complete it, you don't get the necessary distance to pick up the first down. It looks like they're going to be short. Brian Kelly does a nice job of coming up and making the tackle and not allowing Sean Jefferson anywhere to run after catching that ball.
Yeah, but the problem is if you're Sean Jefferson and you've been in the National Football League for 12 years, you don't cut that route off and not pick up the first down. It's a nice play call, nice throw, and Jefferson just messed it up.
Well, if he did miss it, he missed it by inches, and we'll check. And he is literally inches short. So, what do you want to do against the top-rated defense in the NFL near midfield? You want to go for it? That question is confronting Dan Reeves right now.
You know, if you look at the coach's manual, you'd say, no, you don't go for it. You punt when you're on the road. I'd say that when you've got a defense like Atlanta's going up against Tampa Bay's offense, you can afford, if you don't make this first down here, that you can hold them and not give up points.
I think number seven is a manual breaker.
Gets the first down. Vick gets enough for a fresh set of downs and no speed needed there. That's the other thing about Vick. He's not a slight guy at all. I mean, he is built like a big running back, and that's why you see some defenders bounce off him, and here he puts his head down and gets enough for a first down.
Yeah, not an overly tall guy. I think that's the thing that most people dwell on is his height and how that affects him as far as a passer. But you're right, Joe, as a runner, he's got some size to him.
But when you watch him throw the football, it's so effortless. I mean, he really just flicks the football. We saw him in the game last week against Minnesota rolling around and throwing a Hail Mary from his own 35 that went out of the back of the end zone, about 75 yards in the air. It's just phenomenal. He truly is a freak of nature to be the fastest guy in the league, arguably, with the strongest arm in the league.
Still bothering to measure. Clearly a first down, but Tony Corrente brought the sticks out to make sure.
And I think that's probably the thing that has surprised most people the most, is that coming into the league, everyone knew that Mike Vick was a tremendous athlete, great runner, but I don't think anybody thought that he would be able to throw the ball as effectively as what he has. And he admitted that he's got to improve in some areas, but he has thrown the ball much better than a lot of people thought he would this early in his career.
First down across midfield for Atlanta. And a quick throw out to Finneran. And Ryan makes a move and slips. ends up picking up only 2 yards. Derrick Brooks on the stop and out to Los Angeles for a game break. Here's James Brown.
Hey, Joe Buck, Kansas City's Dante Hall had a 90-yard punt return for a touchdown last week. Today, he adds this 88-yard kickoff return to the mix. Two special teams touchdowns in the week. Kansas City is on top now, 7-3 over the Rams. Back to Joe Buck.
JB, thanks. More special teams problems for Bobby April and that group for the Rams. Second down for Atlanta. And this one's batted back. Jefferson, the intended receiver, and Simeon Rice got in the way.
Simeon Rice, he's having a year that he may very well garner NFL Defensive Player of the Year, and he's always been around the ball. You talk about the sacks that he has 14 and a half on the year, but he's always been able to get his hand on the ball this season, and whenever you start trying to throw the short passes, which is what Atlanta's going to want to do because of this pass rush, it's nice when you've got big, tall guys like Simeon Rice who's there to bat those down.
Third and eight. Vick unloads. Gaylor incomplete.
When you end up in a third and long, look at the space right here that Simeon Rice is outside. He's like a sprinter coming around the corner on Bob Whitfield. And look at the little flick by Mike Vick. I mean, he barely even threw the ball and got the ball well almost 50 yards down the field. Unfortunately, if he put a little more steam on it, Troy, I think he'd had a touchdown.
Yeah, Shelton Porter's the linebacker, middle linebacker, running all the way down the field with Trevor Gaylor to help in that defense.
Second punt for Chris Moore. One of the best in the NFL at hang time, and he shows it off here as the catch is made at the 19 by Carl Williams. So the Tampa Bay Buccaneers hold on defense, and Brad Johnson back to the field.
What kind of hot sauce you got?
It's mild, medium, hot, and three-alarm radioactive fireball surprise.
Okay.
That was mild?
Uh-huh.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down.
I guess you don't want to try the medium one.
Make it a Bud Light.
Now there's an American Express card with rewards built in. You can get double rewards points for things you buy every day and a point for virtually every other dollar you spend. So you can earn rewards in double time.
The party is on at the 2002 Billboard Music Awards with performances by Justin Timberlake, Avril Lavigne, Nelly, Creed, Faith Hill. Appearances by Rod Stewart, Cher, Michael Jackson, and more. Live from the MGM Grand in Las Vegas, Cedric the Entertainer hosts the 2002 Billboard Music Awards at 8, 7 Central, Fox Monday.
Little under halfway through the first quarter, and so far the Tampa Bay defense, as advertised, containing Mike Vick. But it's the offense that's the question mark for this Buccaneer team. Unable to run the ball really at all this season. And they try it with Aaron Stecker. Hits the hole hard and picks up 4 yards.
Well, you want to see speed by this Tampa defense. Shelton Quarles right here, number 53, is going to be running down the middle of the field, trying to help in coverage on Trevor Gaylor, who's their speed guy. He's able to get in on the play. That's an example of the kind of speed we're talking about on this Tampa Bay defense, and especially this Tampa linebacker.
Speed or no speed, that ball was underthrown by Mike Vick. A missed opportunity. Now the Buccaneers get it back, second and six. Johnson throws. McCardell gets to the 25. A gain of only two as Draft made the stop. We were down on the field. The footing is not really good on that field right now. It seems a little damp, and we've seen a couple of guys slip already.
But it's not as bad as what it was in Atlanta the first time these two teams met. They had just shampooed the carpet up there, and Mike Vick was telling us last night that he literally couldn't move. He couldn't run around. He couldn't make a cut, and he thought it really worked against him in that game.
Third down and four. Over the middle, that's Jurevicius. And he is hit and dropped at the 30 with a Tampa Bay first down.
Joe Jurevicius is a guy who's gotten more involved in this offense as the season has progressed. And John Gruden really likes him. He's a big target. He's a physical receiver. He does a nice job, especially on those types of routes where he's running the drag route. He picks up key yardage at critical times. There he's able to get the first down.
Tampa Bay would love to use him more in their offense, but they need to have tight ends in the lineup to help protect Brad Johnson. Instead of extra wide receivers, Keyshawn Johnson coming around on a fake end around. And a gain of one by Pittman. We go out to Los Angeles and check in again with JB.
I say it, Joe Buck, Kansas City not letting up at all. Take a look at defensive end Eric Hicks knocking the ball loose from Jamie Martin. Picked up by Dwayne Clemens, 42 yards for the score. The 11th non-offensive touchdown allowed by the Rams. That's a record in the Super Bowl era. Back to Joe Buck.
All right, JB, second down and nine. Ball stop at the backfield. They don't give to him. Johnson looking to throw, and he underthrows McCardell. Let's talk for a moment about this Atlanta defense and really the job that Wade Phillips has done. They were 30th in the NFL last year on defense. Phillips comes in, and people said, well, you don't have the personnel to run a 3-4, and this really isn't your father's or grandfather's 3-4 defense. They use speed. And they have been effective enough to climb all the way up to 15th in the NFL.
They're an undersized defense, but they make up for it with speed. They do have depth at linebacker, which lends itself to the 3-4. They're middle of the road in the stats in the NFL. The big thing is they rank fourth in the NFL in scoring defense, which is the most important stat.
Third down and nine. Johnson fires, and McCardell wide open. Went backward after the catch and is brought down shy of first down yardage. Time for a Tampa punt.
You know, the other thing that we haven't talked about with this Falcon defense is the pressure that they've been getting. We've talked so much about what a great pass rush Tampa Bay has. Well, the Falcons have more sacks than do the Buccaneers. They play a lot of man-to-man coverage back there in the secondary. There's a couple of guys, Ellis Johnson and Brady Smith, over the past five games, about 4.5 sacks each. So this is a very good defensive football team.
Second punt for Tom Tupa. Better this time, and Rawson makes the catch just shy of the 20. Allen Rawson, good return, shows speed. Rawson forced out of bounds by Tupa, the punter, near midfield. A return of 32 yards by Allen Rawson. So it's the veteran who gives Mike Vick and the Atlanta offense good field position here in the first quarter in Tampa with no score.
Another holiday on the credit card, huh?
Yeah, my balance is really piling up. But I'll worry about that in January.
You could get a Capital One no-hassle card.
Nah. I need you!
High interest charges running up your balance? Get the Capital One no-hassle card for the nation's lowest long-term fixed rates, $0 fraud liability, and no telemarketing.
What's in your wallet?
Stevens?
Yeah.
Got you down for over 130 channels, $39.99 a month.
Right. So
every channel's digital quality. There's access to 31 premium movie channels, 60 pay-per-view movie titles a month.
Great. So that can go on the back of the roof?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, good. So go ahead and pull around back.
You work for the cable company, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why settle for cable? Get a two-room DirecTV system with installation for under $50.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by DirecTV. Movies, music, and exclusive sports from the leader in digital satellite entertainment. By Cadillac, bold vehicles defying convention. By Circuit City, we're with you. And by Capital One, what's in your wallet?
All right, somebody bring the spotlight in here. Shine it on Troy Aikman. I'm going to ask you, are you ready to tap Mike Vick as this revolutionary that everybody's talking about?
You know, I don't know how much he has changed the game because there's been other quarterbacks like Donovan McNabb, same style. He just so happens that he's so much faster than everybody else.
T.J. Duckett on a toss running right. Nice pickup on first down inside the 45, a gain of four.
Let's go back to the punt return. Watch Allen Rossum. He's going to wave his arms like, get away from the football. And then he runs up and catches it. Also catches a pretty good block on the outside by Quentin McCourt. But that signal is known by the punt team as well as he's going to let it bounce and then roll on down the field. Rossum used it to his advantage there.
Two-yard return was the result. Good field position for the second time today for this Atlanta offense. Second down and six. Moore with the run game. Moore with Duckett. And he forces his way forward, brought down just shy of first down yardage.
Well, one of the things you're going to see a lot of from this Falcons offense, as you see right here, they got three in the backfield. Algie Crumpler, Bob Christian, and then T.J. Duckett's going to be the ball carrier. And they feel that it's just another way to get extra blockers in the game. And they know that they've got to have some success running the football. And it can't always be Michael Vick carrying that load.
And what's interesting was when they were in that formation a week ago, they ran typically to the outside. Here they start out the game up the middle.
John Lynch, the fantastic strong safety, is down and getting attention.
If you think all batteries are the same, consider this. When monitoring a patient after open heart surgery, the brand of battery hospitals trust most is Duracell. Duracell, trusted everywhere. Still think all batteries are the same? Consider this. When IMAX needed power for their camera, they trusted Duracell. Up there or down here on Earth. Duracell, trusted everywhere.
Dublin, Ohio, a town divided between Wendy's Bacon Swiss Cheeseburger and Wendy's Chicken Bacon Swiss.
People, there's common ground here. Bert and Cindy, don't you both love Swiss?
Yes.
Of course you do. And who here doesn't enjoy hickory smoked bacon? Some like it on a whole breast filet and some on a cheeseburger. But are we going to let that tear us apart?
Yeah. Choose Wendy's Bacon Swiss Cheeseburger or Chicken Bacon Swiss. It's better here.
Wow. MP3 player, digital camera, DVD player. Very nice. Looks like some of these kids are going to be very happy this holiday.
Kids! I'll be right.
Something for everyone. Circuit City has tons of great gift ideas this holiday season. Circuit City, we're with you.
Hey, my wife loves these things. All wives love things. Could you...
Looking for laughs on Sunday night? Then don't miss The Simpsons, King of the Hill, Malcolm and Andy Richter. The best comedies on television.
Help, please!
Don't struggle. You'll only sink faster.
It all starts at 8, 7 Central tonight on Fox.
There was a collective gasp from this big crowd when they saw four-time Pro Bowler John Lynch down and on the ground, then a sigh of relief when he got up and jogged off. Third down and one for the Falcons. No score, first quarter in Tampa. Vick brought down in the backfield. And Lynch's replacement, John Howell, makes a key third down stop.
Well, nobody is better at football than the naked bootleg. than Mike Vick, and yet John Howe, pulled off the bench at the top of your screen, is simply going to read this one out. It is his job to contain that play, and he works it to perfection. You simply cannot allow him to get outside you. If he gets behind you and to the outside, there's too much speed. Perfect contain that time by John Howe.
And just a great defensive call by Monty Kiffin, the defensive coordinator. Third punt of the day from Moore. Beautiful punt. How good is it? Ain't that great. Into the end zone and field position at the 20 for Tampa Bay. The Buccaneers get a great stop in the open field. Howell brings down Vick.
Does Robo Cat cough up Robo hairballs?
It's metal. But that's not the point. The chips that power RoboCat are only manufactured in Palo Alto, but the assembly plant is in Tokyo.
If my girlfriend gets RoboCat, would it be jealous of me?
Of you?
Yeah.
No. Now focus. They ship the chips with FedEx International Services. Get time-definite, reliable service to Tokyo. RoboCat's the biggest thing that hit Japan since Godzilla.
Did I get it?
Yeah, you're fine.
It used to be business was conducted face-to-face, and people were helpful. It was known as common courtesy. At Siebel, we make application software that lets you once again give your customers personalized service. It's made a real difference in a lot of successful companies. It could make one in yours. Siebel, good service is good business.
Introducing Remington's new Microscreen TCT, built for closeness, designed for comfort, with the only triple screen system that automatically adjusts for a closer shave with less irritation. Now, just imagine how it's gonna feel.
I've been really trying, baby.
So you like it, huh?
For the ultimate in closeness and comfort, the new Remington. What a great shave feels like.
There's an easier way to get the gear the pros wear. Call 877-NFL-SHOP for your free team catalog.
Mike Vick so far has 4 yards rushing, which is better by three than what he did the first time these two teams met in Atlanta. But really, this is one of the bigger audiences across the country that's seeing an Atlanta Falcons game and their first look for an entire game at what Mike Vick does. Be interesting to track his progress within this game against this Tampa Bay defense, which so far has shut down the Atlanta attack. Starting from their 20, this is Allstock falling forward for a gain of three. Let's go down to the sideline and check in with Pam Oliver.
All right, Joe, we know safety John Lynch is one of the hardest hitters in the game. Well, he hit so hard on that last play that he suffered a neck strain. His return is questionable. Back to you.
There's Lynch walking off the field into the dressing room as he'll take a look at him. And a look at Travis Hall, who's missed the last couple of games with a foot sprain. Really their only defensive end in this 3-4 that's got some size, nearly a 300-pounder. Second down for Tampa Bay. Over the middle, it's Dilger. And he has a first down. Ken Dilger, who is a great pickup this offseason, played at Indianapolis his first 7 years in the league. He's averaging 40 receptions per year, and that was a position that they wanted more production out of. Last year, Dave Moore was the starter at tight end. They bring in Ken Dilger, and slowly as the season has come along, he's become more a part of what they're doing, and he helps in the shorter passing game that John Gruden has installed. First down, Buccaneers. Johnson hits Jurevicius, another Tampa Bay first down.
One of the things I've always liked about John Gruden's offense, anytime they play against a team that's playing a lot of man-to-man coverage, they'll get in these bunch formations, which makes it very difficult to play man coverage because you can get picked and rubbed off to get open down the field. That time, Jurevicius able to take advantage and basically force Atlanta back into a zone, which they don't like to play as much.
Well, this secondary for Atlanta, they matched up very well last week against Minnesota, went man-to-man coverage on Randy Moss and Buchanan, so they feel that they match up exceptionally well against this Tampa Bay group on first down.
an end around. That's Carl Williams. And he is forced out, lost yardage on the play. A loss of one, and well covered by Atlanta up front. Matt Stewart, one of the linebackers, in to make the play, and with 5 seconds and counting remaining in the first quarter, it is, in a way, exactly what we expected. A defensive struggle here early. No score after one. The NFL on Fox will continue after these messages.
Phone. I gotta get a cordless headset.
Funny how the holidays turn even the most serious business people into kids again. Consider Office Depot your toy store, because our people know exactly what business people want for the holidays, and we offer a wide variety of gifts at great prices. Office Depot. What you need to know.
Golf Saturday?
Can't. Tomorrow weekend with the kids.
You're watching the NFL on Fox.
Come on, hon, just tell me what soaps you want. This isn't really my kind of place.
Dad, I told you, lilac.
Lilac? Just use the stuff I got at the hotel.
Dad.
That's Nextel, right?
Yes.
And the chamomile, too, and a honeysuckle.
How about just some soap-scented soap?
That cell phone with the walkie-talkie, right?
Yeah.
So cool.
You should do their commercials.
Commercials? I want to be a serious actress.
Everybody's got a little Jeep adventure in them. Isn't it time you let yours out? Now during Jeep Adventure Days you can, because during this factory authorized limited time opportunity, you can get 0% APR financing on all 2003 Jeep vehicles and make no monthly payments for 90 days. Plus get our 770 powertrain limited warranty. No one else gives you all that. So hurry to your Jeep dealer and find the Jeep adventure in you. Check one out today.
To the final vote, the next American Idol, this January on Fox.
Well, I guess the question is, how long can you stay on a roll and how long can you keep your emotions high after getting off to that 1-3 start? An 8-game unbeaten streak, and so far, after one quarter, there really isn't a ton of emotion in this game, really, on either side. And what is a huge game in the NFC South. Johnson throws, and he has Dilger. Dilger gets to the 45, and that's all. Next week, it's a Fox NFL Sunday doubleheader, beginning with America's number one pregame show. You know the cast there. Then it's the Seahawks at the Falcons. Falcons could be in first place. They will be if they get a win here today. And then the big second game. Did Chris Collinsworth put a bad star on the Packers at the 49ers? And a matchup of Brett Favre and Jeff Garcia. Favre a little better last week after two rough weeks. One in Minnesota and the other here against the Buccaneer defense. Third down and eight. And a throw for Johnson. Keyshawn Johnson with a first down catch, and one a throw from Brad Johnson.
Well, Atlanta goes to a two-man coverage. You see Bolden, he wants to take away the inside, which is what you want to do. They had the right play called. Keyshawn Johnson fades the route, gives him room for Brad Johnson to throw the football. Just good execution.
And Jerron Bolden was the guy that Keyshawn Johnson in the first game beat for that long 75, 76-yard touchdown pass. Keyshawn was excited about playing in this ballgame because he knew he was going to get some shots.
Yeah, and Bolden, who replaced Buchanan last week, and went man-to-man on Randy Moss most of the afternoon, did a nice job in last week's game.
Here are the Buccaneers with no running game all season. Still no running game today, and that's Pittman out of the backfield. Brought down shy of the 35, a gain of five.
That was interesting talking with John Gruden about his running game yesterday, and he said, hey, you know, I'd love to run the football. When he was with the Oakland Raiders, they were a very good running team. He said, but you have to see some results. You just don't bang it in there time after time and gain a yard, gain 2 yards, and expect me to keep calling those plays.
And I think that's why we're seeing more and more of the shorter passes. He's trying to implement this shorter passing game in lieu of this lack of a running game.
No matter how far these Buccaneers get in January, there are going to be major changes offensively next season for Tampa Bay. You know, movement up front here, Troy, and it is going to cost
encroachment.
Atlanta
defense number 95.
I think there will be some changes, Joe, as you mentioned, and there were some changes coming into this season. They tried to revamp that left side of the offensive line. Of course, Kenyatta Walker got moved to right tackle, but Roman Oben and Kerry Jenkins were pickups this offseason to try to improve what they had up front in the offensive line. They also brought in McCardell and Juravicius along with Michael Pittman, so they've tried to infuse some offensive production, but so far this season, it has not come out of the field.
The spot from which the ball would have been snapped was less than 5 yards from the line to gain. Therefore, the result of the penalty is a first down.
He's basically reacting to Dan Reeves, but instead of talking to Reeves one-on-one, he addresses a television audience, a crowd here at Raymond James Stadium, and says, look, Dan, I'm telling you, the next play was going to be for less than 5 yards. Therefore, a five-yard penalty is a first down.
Dan Reeves intimidates a lot of people.
Heck yeah. On first down, Allstott. Mike Allstott. Tripped up and brought down shy of the end zone. 27 yards.
The one thing that, as I watch the Atlanta Falcons defense, they love to crash their ends down. And sometimes they get themselves in trouble and they get themselves hooked on the outside. They've always been vulnerable to bootlegs. They've been vulnerable to reverses. And here Allstott sets them up to the inside, bounces it outside for a big gainer.
They're going to mark Allstott down at the 3. And it's first and goal for Tampa Bay. The Buccaneers have only 4 rushing touchdowns all season, and Allstott has all of them. Good one here. Good pressure up front. A loss on the play.
On the carry.
Nick Burrows comes away with a football. But they're going to say that Allstott's progress had been stopped, and Tampa Bay hangs on to the ball, second and goal.
Well, and Mike Allstott, he has all of the rushing touchdowns for this offense this year, which amount to 4. Not very productive. On the other hand, Atlanta, to give you some kind of point of reference, they have 22 rushing touchdowns. They brought in Darian Barnes as a fullback. He lined up there on that play thinking that he could be more of a battering ram. That's the one position that they've lacked, and it's hurt them when they've gotten into some short yardage situations.
And center Jeff Christie was really writhing in pain coming out of that pile. You have to keep an eye on him.
Penalty flags before the snap.
The flag on the offense was thrown for 12 men in the huddle.
So that's going to move the ball back near the 10-yard line.
Yeah, and that's what happens sometimes when you're substituting a lot of people. And what teams used to do is they'd get 12, 13 people in the huddle, and right before they broke to go to the line of scrimmage, they would get guys off the field so that they had their 11. And what it did was it kept defenses from knowing what personnel was going to play, and then they couldn't substitute their own people to match, and that's why they now have the rule that you can't have 12 people in the huddle.
Well, they have yet to mark off the penalty, and Dan Reeves is in the face of Tony Correnti, our referee today. Well, there's confusion down on the field, and this is a bad day for Mike Pereira, the NFL official supervisor, to be here watching this.
The runner penetrating the line of scrimmage, progress being stopped, is non-reviewable. However, the penalty for 12 men in the huddle will be enforced. 5-yard penalty against the offense.
So Reeves was upset that they couldn't review the fumble by Allstott and that his forward progress had been stopped, and Chris is going to count all the people in the huddle. I'm assuming Keyshawn Johnson is out to the side there. Yes. So that's going to mark it back to the 10, and it's second and goal. Brad Johnson finds Juravicius. Penalty flag on the play. And we'll check the marker.
Pass interference. Defense
touchdown.
Number 56. This penalty will be declined. Touchdown.
That's
tell you, this is a good design by John Gruden and what they're doing. They isolate Jurevicius on the linebacker, Keith Brooking. That's just a heck of a throw right there. Great concentration while he's getting mauled by Joe Jurevicius.
Heck of a throw. You like the catch better, Chris, didn't you?
Great catch.
Pretty good throw, too.
That's a great catch.
Martin Gramatica tacks on the extra point. Johnson perfect on the drive. 6 for 6. Jurevicius in, and the Buccaneers strike first.
Come on, man, do it.
Wait, an electric dog collar? I will never do that.
No, it really doesn't hurt.
No, we'll tell everyone you did it.
Oh, great.
Life is best told over a great tasting Miller Lite at a place called Miller Time.
You sure it's off?
I promise you,
sure?
It's off. Don't you worry.
The Citizen Echo Drive. It never needs a battery because light recharges it. So, what will you do with your battery now that your watch doesn't need one?
Feast your eyes on the new fajita grilled stuffed burrito from Taco Bell. Sizzling strips of marinated steak and grilled veggies. All the great fajita flavors now wrapped to go in a grilled tortilla.
Ooh, fajitas.
Ooh, fajitas.
Taste the new fajita grilled stuffed burrito and think outside the bun.
Powerful new Silverado is here. Still available with the 340 horse Vortec V8.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Chevy Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. By Citizen Echo Drive, a revolutionary watch that never needs a battery. By Taco Bell, think outside the bun. And by Office Depot, what you need to know.
Great drive, perfect drive for Brad Johnson. Then you know that Joe Jurevicius last night, when he was going to sleep, thought, how can I mock the Dirty Bird? And he got his chance moments ago as Gramatica kicks it away, and Alan Rawson will watch it take a bounce and take it near the one. Well covered downfield. That's Ivy making the stop.
We should change before we pick up the girls. Okay.
Chevy Avalanche. It changes from a pickup to an SUV.
What are you doing?
Avalanche. Like a rock.
Take all the time you want, folks.
We'll take this one in red.
Beautiful choice, sir.
No, black.
Black.
That's actually my favorite color.
Red. Definitely red.
With Microsoft Server software, you can quickly connect with customers. That's software for the agile business from Microsoft.
I usually don't ski the Northeast, but mountains are so tiny.
Of course, I really haven't had much time for skiing lately. What with making Varner down on Wall Street.
Looking for an even more satisfying crunch? Grab a Snickers Cruncher. Peanuts, caramel, chocolate, and crunchies. Snickers Cruncher. Beyond crunchy.
Chicken. Introducing Domino's Pizza Buffalo Chicken Kickers. Tender cuts of all-white chicken breast with a kick of spicy buffalo flavor baked through and through. 10 pieces for $5.99. Get the door and get a kick out of dinner tonight. Get an order of Cinesticks free when you buy a large one-topping pizza for $9.99.
The threat is growing.
They found nuclear material.
The clock is ticking.
I don't know any terrorists!
And the next twist is beyond words.
Step out of the car and open up the trunk.
No, my God! 24, all new. 9/8 Central, Fox Tuesday.
some life around this joint. 7-0 Tampa Bay. Mike Vick and the Falcons will start at their own 15. Duckett. We haven't seen Warrick done yet all day, and Duckett falls forward for three.
Go back to the touchdown. Once again, this bunch formation over here is what is going to allow Juravicius to work one-on-one on Keith Brooking. He has to read the release and take whoever it is that comes to the inside. Makes it virtually impossible to play bump and run man-to-man with your corners, so you end up with a matchup of a wide receiver on a linebacker. Works for a touchdown.
Johnson found him for the score. Mike Vick said this was going to be his best game of the season. He's got 2+ quarters to make that a reality. Tough to beat last week. 2nd and 7. Brooks.
Derek Brooks, who's just had an outstanding season up to this point. You see, he holds his ground, waiting to see in case Michael Vick decides to put the ball down and run, and in the process, gets in the throwing lane of where Vick was trying to throw the ball to Reggie Kelly.
Flag on the play, and Vick is forced out of bounds short of the first down.
They flip-flopped their pass rush that time, Troy. They brought Warren Sapp and Simeon Rice over here to the left-hand side, and I think Sapp ended up getting held on the play. He broke through completely clean, and they had no choice. Garza simply had to tackle.
There's a hold that should be declined.
There's Sapp right there, working against Garza, and Garza is so used to him being on the other side, just had to grab the back of his jersey.
63. This penalty is declined. Fourth down.
Garza jumps to the outside, thinking he's going to get help from his center, McClure. That opens up the lane for Warren Sapp to get inside, and if you don't want to get your quarterback hit, he grabbed him.
Maybe that's one of those things that Monty Kiffin stayed up late at night working on this week.
Well, this Tampa Bay team has been known as one of the best defensive teams in the league. You go back to a record-setting year for them in 99. This defense is playing
better
than that team that ended up in the NFC Championship game. Penalty flag as Williams was not allowed to get to the football on the punt.
Flag.
And this is going to cost Atlanta. 51-yard punt. But there was interference on the play.
Interference with the opportunity to catch the kick. Kicking team number 47. The ball will be placed at the spot of the foul. First down.
9:47 left, and we understand that number 47 for the Bucs, Lynch, will be left on the bench the rest of the day. He will not return.
Life is full of difficult choices, and some not so difficult. When you purchase an elegantly redesigned mid-sized 2003 Saturn L Series, you can choose $2,500 toward your down payment. Or get 0% financing, zero down payment, and zero payments for 90 days. Unfortunately, this not-so-difficult choice ends January 2nd. Purchase a 2003 Saturn L Series and get $2,500 toward down payment. Or 0% APR, zero down payment, and zero monthly payment for 90 days. See participating retailer for restrictions.
Please enter password. Please scan retina. Please submit blood sample. Please submit hair sample.
Can your security software protect your entire enterprise without making you jump through hoops?
Ready for that 10 o'clock game?
Coming.
Ours can. Comprehensive security solutions from Computer Associates.
Welcome to the kingdom.
How
Are we there yet?
No.
Are we there yet?
No.
Simpsons Talking Watches, now only at Burger King. Just $2.39 each with the purchase of any value meal.
Cool your jets, man.
Burger.
Collect all four. And our big double cheeseburger is just 99 cents. With two slices of melted cheese and two juicy flame broiled patties. More beef than a big and tasty. Hurry, offers end soon.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Saturn, makers of The View, redesigned L Series, and the all new Ion.
The referee, Tony Correnti, misspoke going to break. It's a 15-yard penalty. It's from the spot of the foul. There's the foul, if there is one. And I think you could make the case that Dwight Smith interfered more with Carl Williams than McAdam did. And with the penalty, it's going to move the ball all the way to the Atlanta 45.
Well, McAdam did get his foot underneath the returner and tripped him a bit, and I guess that's what they called.
But Reeves again was hot over on the sideline and in the face of today's referee. Good field position for Tampa Bay. Pittman out of the backfield. Stewart, the first one there. A gain of only one. What's at stake today? Take the division out of it for a moment, and the winner of today's game clinches a playoff berth with the Giants loss, and the Giants are playing in Washington. And the Giants are winning 3-0. Thank you, Troy.
You're welcome, Joe.
Whatever we can do for you, big guy. Appreciate it.
Second down and 9. Draw play, Pittman to the 40. It'll be third down and 5 as we go to Los Angeles. Check in with James Brown on a game break.
All right, Joe, hey, let's take a look at how St. Louis capitalized on his 51-yard drive as Jamie Martin hooks up 8 yards to Isaac Bruce, his 6th receiving touchdown of the season. St. Louis has narrowed the gap to 4 with Kansas City. Back to Joe, Troy, and Chris.
Injured Falcon is number 55.
All right, JB, thanks. A couple of injuries on that last play. Kearney came limping off the field, and John Theory, who's a rush linebacker, is down and getting attention.
Yeah, Patrick Kearney right here, number 97, and boy, if they lose him, that's going to be a huge loss. He led the team last year in 12 sacks. This year he has 8.
So Kearney out and Theory out for the moment.
So 20 seconds left. Garcia looks left.
He's got this weak side blitz coming, right?
Takes a snap. It's a three-step drop.
Bunch of big guys trying to kill him.
Dodges this one safety. Ducks under this tackle.
Launches this awkward, just squirrely-looking deal to Ika Yao Yao Huang.
Prayer to the corner of the end zone.
Right into the hand of J.J. Stokes.
Touchdown.
Touchdown!
Should have been there.
Should have been there.
You should have been there.
If you want to be there, bring your Visa card, because you can't buy 49er tickets at 3Com Park with American Express.
You should have been there.
The Citizen Echo Drive. It never needs a battery, because light recharges it. So, what will you do with your battery now that your watch doesn't need one?
It's a deal worth a double take. It's Applebee's new Take Two. Choose two from 4 delicious entrees to make one mouth-watering plate. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Father, give me the strength for what I must do.
Everything we are.
This is a free country, but not free for the taking.
Everything we believe in first had to be fought for in the streets. The motion picture event of the year.
This is a night for America!
Leonardo DiCaprio, Daniel Day-Lewis, Cameron Diaz. Gangs of New York. Rated R. In theaters nationwide Friday, December 20th.
See performances by Justin Timberlake, Avril Lavigne, Nelly, Creed, Faith Hill. Plus appearances by Cher, Michael Jackson, and more. Live, Cedric the Entertainer hosts the 2002 Billboard Music Awards at 8, 7 Central, Fox Monday.
They were looking at the right knee of Patrick Kearney. Theory also off the field. It's third down and 5. Johnson with pressure behind him, and the throw knocked away by Buchanan.
I don't think there's much choice now for the Atlanta Falcons than to start bringing some blitzes. That time they brought the corner down here off the bottom of the screen and having to play man coverage. And it looks like for Ray Buchanan, maybe he's starting to get loosened up a little bit. That's really the first time they've tried to test him today. But they really still haven't gotten him running across the field or having to do any sort of sudden change of direction. I'm surprised they haven't tried more against him directly.
A punt from Tupa. Lawson lets it go over his head and into the end zone.
Touchback.
Next month, Fox Sports Net introduces 5-4-3-2-1, the only show that takes you inside the world of extreme sports each and every night with breaking news, event highlights, and inside features you won't find anywhere else. 5-4-3-2-1 is the entire world of extreme sports all in one place. Troy?
Premiering weeknights next month only on Fox Sports Net.
5-4-3-2-1.
There's all the extreme sport guys right there, man. Every one of those guys. Riding bicycles, skateboards, doing flips, all kinds of stuff.
Well, Mike Vick brings the offense and his chapstick back out to work with him.
1 yard.
Starting from their own 20. Vick lets it go, and it's tipped and picked off by Jackson. Dexter Jackson out of bounds. Inside the 10.
It was interesting last night talking with Monty Kiffin and him talking about the difference that Dexter Jackson has made for this football team this year. He has been around the football on a lot of occasions. Here he gets a deflection. He's in a position to make the play. Nice concentration, good interception by Dexter Jackson, and Brian Finneran might have had an opportunity to haul that one in.
Warren Sapp is going to go right through the running back Christian and grab Michael Vick's foot, and then Rondé Barber with the breakup that led to the interception. Great play by Rondé on the outside.
Dan Reeves' first key to success for the Falcons today was to not turn the ball over. Buccaneers defense specializes in getting turnovers. Penalty flag on the play, and Allstott ends up losing yardage on the play.
Flag.
And the penalty against Tampa Bay. Well, we haven't seen anything from Vick so far. John Gruden calling him a revolutionary, and before he's tabbed as the next Paul Revere, we'll see how he does against one of the game's best defensive coordinators, Monty Kiffin, and this group, which would seem to play well against Mike Vick because of their defensive scheme.
Yeah, and they've played well against the teams that they've gone up against this season that have mobile quarterbacks, Donovan McNabb, Dante Culpepper, Aaron Brooks. Those guys, they've had tremendous success, and they also had success earlier in the season against Mike Vick because
illegal use of the hands, hands to the face, offense number 67. This penalty is declined, second down.
And they've had success because they have great team speed. It's not because of their scheme, what they try to do. They've got great team speed, and they've got great talent that more times than not just outmatches the offenses that they're facing.
And just by the scheme with a two-deep zone where you're not running off the secondary, the cornerbacks, where they're playing facing the quarterback, not getting taken out of the play by a wide receiver, it really plays well for the Buccaneers to contain Mike Vick.
That's a great point because a lot of his big runs have come against teams that are playing man-to-man coverage.
Second down and goal. Back near the 15, a flip and a catch. Second of the day for Jurevicius.
Falcons tried to play man-to-man coverage against that bunch. They saw Ray Buchanan, who's been struggling with that abdomen strain, and just tossed it up in the air. Ray not able to elevate the way that he typically can, and Jurevicius just goes over the top and makes the play.
And Brad had Jurevicius or Keenan McCardell right there for the touchdown.
Romanica to make it a 14-point lead. Does. If there's a big difference with the wide receivers against these cornerbacks, it's the size factor. And Jurevicius, the big wide receiver, gets up, comes down and spreads the magic.
Now through Sunday at Zales, take up to an extra $300 off, even on sale prices, on diamonds throughout the store. Like this $9.99 2-carat diamond necklace, now just $8.49. And this stunning $19.99 8-carat diamond bracelet for only $16.99. That's up to an extra $300 off, even on sale prices, now through Sunday. At Zales, the diamond store.
Well, I guess, guys, it was Ray Buchanan who started the whole pass the magic. Somebody gets an interception, they get down and they move their fingers at one another.
A little voodoo kind of stuff.
Pass the magic, and Jurevicius has now mocked the Dirty Bird, a Jamal Anderson reference, and now pass the magic.
Yeah, I think it was Ray Buchanan and Jamal Anderson, you're right, that started the whole Dirty Bird thing, which is when they went on to go to the Super Bowl, and this year this pass the magic thing, and Joe Jurevicius has been studying up on some of these things that the Falcons have been doing over the last few years.
Tell you what, this Buccaneers defense has been studying up on Michael Vick, too. Yeah. They made him look pretty bad after he looked like Superman last week.
Well, he shouldn't feel too bad at this point because the Buccaneers defense has made a lot of quarterbacks look bad this year.
Rawson waiting for the kick, which goes out of bounds, and there's a mistake, a big one by Gramatica. It'll give the Falcons field position out at their own 40 as they trail by 14. Well, that was a nice moment before the game when Martin Gramatica came up to you specifically and shook your hand and introduced himself. Share some of that time you had with our audience?
It was a special moment, you're right. Yeah, I don't know that I would have described it quite the same way. You know, Gramatica, he has been struggling. I'm wondering if it's the first time he's ever come up to me like that. I'm wondering if he thought, hey, if I do something like what he just did and kick it out of bounds, right, maybe we'll go a little lighter on him.
Go ahead, rip him, man. Show him he's wrong.
Pass him some magic.
Keep it on the field. It's a big field.
Vick with a toss for Duckett. Still no signs of Warren Dunn. And Duckett, a nice gain on first down. He picked up 7. Let's go down to Pam Oliver.
All right, Joe, a couple of injury updates for the Falcons. Defensive end Patrick Kearney knew something was bad when he got hurt on that play. He came off the field, threw his helmet violently to the sideline. The Falcons playing it very careful right now, just saying he has a right knee injury. Trainers continue to work on him, and Kearney continued to try to work that thing out. Meanwhile, John Theory got hit down low, but he is okay. Back to you.
Thanks, Pam. Second down and 3. Down a yard shy of a first down. 3rd and 1 coming up out to Los Angeles. A game break. Here's JB.
Hey, Joe, we talked about it during the pregame show against man defense. A quarterback can take it to the house. Well, it hasn't happened for Vic, but it did happen here for Jeff Garcia. 21 yards, 7-6 San Francisco. Priest Holmes, 11th consecutive game with a touchdown. He's got 23 on the season, 3 shy of Marshall Faulk's record. Kansas City up by 11. Back to Joe Buck.
JB, thanks. It's 3rd and 1 here. Duckett just lowers his head and pushes the pile forward for a first down.
Well, that time is a perfect play call by the Atlanta Falcons. Warren Sapp came on a stunt down to the inside, which allowed this hole to open up to the outside. In that full house backfield, you've got bodies on bodies across the way, and it's really been very effective this year for the Falcons, especially last couple of weeks.
It's only the 2nd first down of the day for Atlanta, and the ball's inside Tampa Bay territory. Buccaneer defense giving up the fewest points in the NFL this season. Simeon Rice was held on the play. 2 penalty flags for separate fouls. There's a hold on the Atlanta Falcons, but then one came flying in from the secondary. Rice was held. That was easy to see, and we'll check and see what the other marker may be.
Holding, offense, number 70. Holding, defense,
Who was it? What number was it? Who was it?
Number 25.
Number 25.
I rule these penalties offset. Replay, first down.
That was Bob Whitfield for the Falcons at left tackle, who was holding Simeon Rice. See him on the outside. You see right there clearly, as you said, Joe, grabbing him. And then downfield, Brian Kelly working against Brian Finneran. And that's within 5 yards. He can throw him like that. Must have traveled outside the 5-yard zone.
So it's first and 10. Buccaneers showing blitz. They come, and Vick's in trouble. Gets rid of it, throws it away. It was outside the pocket, so no flag. Second and 10 coming up. Rice with more pressure.
Now, I was talking with Simeon Rice before the game. He said, I can't wait for Michael Vick to try and run that bootleg on me. He has no idea how fast I am. Forget about how fast he is. I'm faster than he is, and I'm going to catch him on the outside. And when he circles out around me, I'm going to get him.
I was talking to Simeon Rice also before the game, and I told him I was running out of superlatives to say about his play. He's been so outstanding, and I asked him to come up with a word for me. He told me to say off the hook. If I could say that Simeon Rice is playing off the hook, that would be a real compliment. So he's off the hook as far as I'm concerned.
I talked to the security guard in the booth before the game. Vick brought down at the 41, a gain of 5. Third down coming up.
So what Simeon Rice has done over the past 5 weeks is truly remarkable. And I know it's not a quarterback stat or a wide receiver stat, but to have at least 2 sacks in each of the last 5 games, it's never been done in the history of the league. And I told him if he got 2 more today, I was going to compare him to DiMaggio.
Well, there's many that say that he should get Defensive Player of the Year. And another guy who should be considered is Derek Brooks, his teammate.
Here they go back to that formation again with Rice and Sapp over here on the left-hand side.
Quick throw, and there's the arm strength like a bullet out to Jefferson for a first down.
Yeah, and I think that's the thing that Michael Vick is going to continue to improve on. You saw there he drops back. He knows exactly where he's going with the football, gets rid of it on time, and as a result, they get the first down. And this is an area that Michael Vick told us that he feels like he needs to improve on a little bit, that he's got such good vision that somehow they're trying to slow his vision down because he sees guys as covered because he sees the field so quickly, and it's trying to slow the vision down so that he can sit in the pocket and deliver some of those throws.
From the 35, play action. Vick, like dancing through the raindrops, fires in, it's caught. That's the big tight end, Crumpler, still going down to the 15.
Well, here you go. Exactly why Michael Vick is considered the MVP candidate. He simply makes this all by himself, and Troy, he does it moving to the right, which he hasn't done a lot of.
You know, and a lot of quarterbacks have a hard time moving opposite of their throwing hand, and he moves to his right, and he does a good job of continuing to look down the field for receivers, and sometimes quarterbacks don't do that. They're quick to put the ball down, but he has the presence of mind of knowing where Crumpler is and gets him the ball.
Vick vision showing you a pretty good catch from Algie Crumpler. About 3.5 to play in the half, and Bobby Christian picks up 2.
One of the things you have to do against this Buccaneers defense is continue with the body shots. Remember, this drive started with some runs to T.J. Duckett. When you go back over the history of this defense, there have been three games in which they've been gouged a little bit, and typically it's up the middle. Deuce McAllister got him twice for around 100 yards, and Deuce Staley for 152, but you have to stay with that run, otherwise that pass rush is just too good.
Second down and 8. Christian. Nothing. Gain of only 1.
Boy, Derek Brooks is just too fast, isn't he? I mean, that guy, you think you're going to make the corner, and he just is faster than your running backs.
Yeah, you're just not going to be able to run wide on this football team, particularly with Bob Christian. Bob Christian has gotten more involved in this running game in recent weeks, but it's been primarily in shorter yardage situations and when he's running north and south. Not the guy you want to get the football to try to outflank this Tampa defense.
What will Vick do on third and seven? McFarland got a hand on it. Almost looked like they were setting up a screen, and it's fourth down.
Yeah, it looked like they were trying to run a middle screen, but just nowhere to throw the ball. And it's actually the tight end. See him right here. It's Crumpler that came up late. Looked like that's who Vick was trying to get the football to.
Remember, we were watching the film of these guys last week against the Minnesota Vikings, and their screen game is just terrible. It's really time in key situations to get away from that because they do it so poorly.
30-yard drive for Feely. And the Falcons are on the board, but Feely was hit after the kick. This is going to be against Tampa Bay. And if it is, and it's a personal foul, then you have the decision as to whether you want to take points off the board. But it's only a five-yarder, which would not give Atlanta a first down, so they will decline the penalty.
Running into the kicker, receiving team, the penalty is declined. Result of the play is a touchdown.
Running into as opposed to roughing.
I don't get that. I mean, if you're going to hit the guy in his follow-through motion, how can it not be roughing the kicker?
Well, I believe they view it as the severity of the hit.
I mean, as a kicker, what's worse than that? On your follow-through, you're going to get hit?
I don't know. You saw Dan Reeves' face on the sidelines. He certainly was thinking it should have been a personal foul.
As it is, 3 points for Atlanta.
My son Donovan and I are making sure everyone in Philly is eating good.
Hey, what are you doing?
You need some nice, hot, chunky soup to fill you up right.
Campbell's Chunky Sirloin Burger. Big chunks of veggies and hearty sirloin burgers grilled to perfection.
How can I thank you guys?
Donovan!
Oh, Mom, one more?
Campbell's Chunky Sirloin Burger fills you up right.
Reminder, fans, stadium guests are not permitted to leave.
Well, Chris, I would agree with you. The call on that penalty was just running into the kicker. Feely was hit on his follow-through, and instead of a personal foul, and then again, you have the decision to make. Do you want to take the points off the board, put your offense back out there? I bet if they had the chance, they would have done it.
Yeah, apparently, if you hit the kicking leg, it's running into. If you hit the plant leg, it's roughing, but seems like an interesting distinction to me.
That ball out of the back of the end zone, and Brad Johnson of the Tampa Bay offense with just 2:02 remaining in the first half and an 11-point lead.
Touchback.
We'll head back to work. Are you as surprised at the play this season, Brad Johnson? I know John Gruden is to a certain extent.
Well, you have to look at what he has around him. And with this offensive line playing as poorly as they have with the pass protection, with the inability to run the football, with the lack of a superstar running back or a really big play deep threat, you really have to say that Brad Johnson's year in keeping this team alive and doing as well as they have so far with the season, he really and truly to me is the MVP, at least on the offensive side of this team.
Good sign for Atlanta as Patrick Kearney, bad knee and all, is back in the lineup for the Falcons. A toss to Pittman running right. This will take us to the two-minute warning, and it's a gain of only two. A minute 57 remaining in what is a big game for each side, and the Buccaneers lead by 11.
Timeouts remaining.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Gateway, a better way.
I loaded our new MP3 player last night with all of our favorite songs.
Gateway PCs feature Intel Pentium 4 processors.
Life is full of difficult choices, and some not so difficult. When you purchase an elegantly redesigned mid-size 2003 Saturn L Series, you can choose $2,500 toward your down payment. Or get 0% financing, zero down payment, and zero payments for 90 days. Unfortunately, this not-so-difficult choice ends January 2nd. Purchase a 2003 Saturn L Series and get $2,500 toward down payment. Or 0% APR, zero down payment, and zero monthly payment for 90 days. See participating retailer for restrictions.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Man, it doesn't show signs of stopping, and I brought me some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low, let it snow, let it snow.
It's the Visa halftime coming up.
Tainted love.
Go, big guy.
Feel I've got to get away.
JB, Terry, Howie, and Jimmy will have scores and highlights from around the league, and the Fox Sports ticker will keep you updated with up-to-the-second stats.
But you know, the problem is, if you sing, that means Terry has to sing. So during halftime, now we're going to hear him
That's
sing.
That's fine.
Is that all right?
I'm not opposed to that. I would imagine it was the complaints by Bruce Springsteen and the E Street Band when they were in Tampa, complaining of the loud sound system here at Raymond James Stadium, might have toned it down a little bit.
It helps.
Jurevicius, his fifth catch, and he fights his way forward, knocked down right at the first down marker. How about Joe Jurevicius popping up out of nowhere today?
Well, he's having a heck of a ball game, and you know, Joe Jurevicius earlier in the season wasn't getting his opportunities, but he's making the most of them today.
But he's also working against the banged-up Ray Buchanan.
First down, Johnson throws, and Pittman was left alone by Brooking. Pittman inside the 30. Timeout, Tampa Bay.
Well, we saw earlier when Brookings was caught in single coverage. Here he's going to have Pittman. You see right here, and Pittman just puts a heck of a move on him. Starts to the outside, plants his outside leg, comes back inside, runs a good route. Middle of the field open due to coverage. Big game.
Well, they sure are expecting a lot out of Keith Brooking in coverage today. We've seen him earlier give up the touchdown to Jurevicius in man coverage, and now the big play to Pittman. And people have been waiting for these kinds of plays out of Michael Pittman all season long. He's a guy they thought might help this running game here, but really has not. But Brad Johnson, when you talk to him about the passing game, he loves the fact that he has somebody with that kind of quickness that he can dump the football to and make some plays.
Here's another look at it. You're going to see the coverage here. They're in man-to-man, and Brookings coming up to take Pittman, opens it up right here, and there's just nobody here in the middle of the field. That's why he was as open as what he was.
From the 28, it's a first down. Already leading by 11, all stop. Down inside the 25. John Gruden saying yesterday, we got the A-train, but we just can't get them on the track.
Yeah, they haven't been able to get anybody on the track, and that's why they've gotten the ball a little bit today to Aaron Stecker. And Michael Pittman is a guy who I really like to watch run the football. I mean, he runs exceptionally hard, but that has been to his detriment because John Gruden is trying to get him to slow down so he'll see the holes better, but they haven't been able to do much of that so far.
47 seconds and counting remaining in the first half. The Buccaneers with two timeouts. Keyshawn Johnson, his first of the day, and a first down inside the 15.
Well, now, because they've been burned in man coverage, the Atlanta Falcons are a little bit out of character. They're dropping back into those zones and are getting picked apart in that, too.
The cannon just went off. The Buccaneers are inside the 20.
Wow, enter to win a trip to the big game with John Elway.
People, let me tell you about my best friend. He's a warm-hearted person who loves me till the end. People, let me tell you about him. He's so much fun. Yeah, he's my best friend.
Enter to win a trip to the big game with John Elway. Odds of winning dependent on number of entries. Odds of becoming John Elway's best friend, not as good.
John Gruden is a beauty in many different ways, but when his quarterback, Brad Johnson, was critical of the use of the cannon on that pirate ship here in this stadium, blasting it three times when they get inside the red zone, Gruden played to the crowd and said, I love that cannon.
Yeah, he threw Brad Johnson overboard, didn't he?
They changed it. They only blew it once. Blown coverage. Touchdown, McCardell. NFL guys waiting to watch Mike Vick today, but it's been Brad Johnson, clearly the better quarterback.
Yeah, now it's Mark McCardell's opportunity to get into the end zone, and you're right, Joe, a lot of talk about Michael Vick. Brad Johnson, the guy right now who's making it happen at quarterback.
With 34 seconds remaining in the first half.
You know, one of the big differences in this ball game is the fact that the offensive line for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers is doing a tremendous job. Yes, the Falcons have some guys hurt, but in that first ball game, they only got two sacks against Brad Johnson, but they hit him 14 out of 30 throws. And yet in this ball game today, the protection has been there, and when Brad Johnson and these receivers get some time, pretty tough to stop them.
Well, and the other thing too, Chris, to follow up on that is last week, Brad Johnson was sacked six times against New Orleans and got hit an awful lot, and was visiting with Wade Phillips, the defensive coordinator for the Falcons, before the game, and he thought that he could get pressure on Brad Johnson with just four guys. And they never bring more than five, but I would expect here in the second half to start seeing the Falcons bring five and some secondary blitzes to try to get some pressure on Brad Johnson.
Yeah, but then you're back into man coverage with Ray Buchanan with the bad leg and Jaron Bolden, who's clearly been struggling against this football team. But this also is probably the best we have seen the Buccaneers offense all season.
They've been able to run the ball just enough to keep the Atlanta defense honest. And in this quarter, the passing yards for Brad Johnson, 122 to Mike Vick's 26.
You just can't say enough about the job Brad Johnson's done all season.
No penalty flag with the play clock winding down to zero on the kick. Alan Rossum. Hello. Darian Barnes. 27 seconds remaining in this first half. They changed the face of Sunday pregame shows. Now they're looking to change Saturday nights as well. Next month, Fox NFL Saturday Night. JB, Terry, Howie, Jimmy, along with Jillian and Jimmy Kimmel, take the show you know and love to a whole new place, prime time. A Fox NFL Saturday Night, January 18th, only on Fox and running through the mind of Chris Collinsworth. As if I didn't join these two guys in the booth, I too could be mugging into the camera with my thumbs up.
Boy, have those guys changed since I left.
Three timeouts remaining for Atlanta. Down by 18. Christian is hammered by Brooks.
I think it's just about time to go ahead and let that clock run out. Going at halftime, see if you can't figure something out. Brooks hanging around the middle basically as a spy on Vick, but this time the spy got Christian.
Give him a going ahead.
Well, that's what Bob Whitfield, he was talking to Vick, and he said, let's let this one just run out.
The score at the end of 30 minutes of play, 21-3. Stay tuned for the Visa Halftime Report. JB, Terry, Howie, and Jimmy right after this. And a word from your local Fox station. Dancing all over the place by the...
Meet Evan, a bachelor who earns $19,000 a year.
Great hair, great eyes, great body.
And meet the 20 women who are about to compete for his heart. Why? They think he's worth $50 million. Now, who would ever give him that idea? Can true love survive a little $50 million lie? Joe Millionaire, a new reality series with a twist.
It's a dream come true.
Brad, 21-3, Tampa Bay on top. We get ready for the start of the second half. Let's go down to the field and check in again with Pam Oliver.
All right, thanks a lot, Joe. Did a great job coaching the first half with that Vick puzzle. How can you continue that in the second half?
Got to keep puzzling him. We got to stay after him, put pressure on him, and try and contain him. He's a great player.
and we realize that.
Okay, that's all we need. Thanks, Coach. Appreciate your time. Let's go back up to Joe.
Let's look at this defense today, guys. Is anybody really surprised that this defense is doing this well against Vic?
Well, even Superman has kryptonite, and it looks like it's Tampa Bay defense for Mike Vick. But if there's one guy I had to pick out of the crowd today, it'd be Derek Brooks. They've used him in there as a spy, but he's also been involved in so many different plays and really disrupted this offense for the Falcons.
Yeah, and then I think you coming into this game, as we talked about, the big story was Michael Vick and his opportunity for everybody to get a chance to see him play. And you know, Brad Johnson, I mean, he's done what he's been doing all season long, having another great game today. And I just feel that he's one of the guys in this league that just has not gotten the recognition that he deserves for his performance.
Talk about Derek Brooks. How about 10 tackles and one pass defended? He's a guy that I think, even as good as he's been, gets lost in the shuffle because now everybody's talking about Simeon Rice. They've always talked about Warren Sapp and John Lynch, but don't forget the guy that bridges the gap there in the middle.
Well, you also have to give a little credit on the outside to the guys, Simeon Rice, and certainly Warren Sapp has played well. But when you play against this Buccaneers defense, they pretty well keep the outside contained. So now you're forced to go up the middle, and when you go up the middle, there's Derek Brooks.
Well, the Atlanta defense will start the second half on the field, and the defense going to have to try to help get Atlanta on the scoreboard more, as the offense hasn't been able to do much, led by Michael Vick against Brooks and company. Buccaneers don't turn the ball over a lot, number two in the NFL in turnover margin. And this is Aaron Stecher waiting, takes it 3 yards deep in the end zone and is tripped up. The ball popped out, but Stecher is down just across the 20. We'll give him the 21-yard line. And so far for Brad Johnson, a lot of short throws and a lot of completion.
Yeah, nothing over 20 yards even attempted. But, you know, this 10 to 19-yard range, he's been perfect. And then 11 of 14 here under 10. And that's, I'm surprised they haven't taken a shot or two down the field. They talked to us about something that's what they wanted to do. They wanted to work against Ashley Ambrose, number 33, their corner, but so far they've yet to do that.
That's the only thing they haven't done so far.
From their own 21, first down, Tampa Bay, and a give to Allstott, the up back. And Mike got a couple over the left side. We go back down to the field, and again, Pam Oliver.
All right, Joe, that pressure you guys talked about for the first half, Dan Reed seems to think the Falcons' biggest problems haven't been with schemes, but rather just too many mistakes on defense. Reeve said our problem, though, is just offense. We need to settle down. He said Mike Vick, he's doing fine, but Tampa's defense is good, you know. And he also says we've just got to keep doing what we do. Back to you.
So far, what they've done is fall into an 18-point hole. Opening minute of the second half, second down and 8. Johnson over the middle is tight end Dilger's wide open. Brought down a few yards shy of a first down. The statistics at halftime, only one turnover today. And that came on an interception picked off by Dexter Jackson on a deflection. And the rush yards about even. How about the pass yards for Mike Vick?
That's it. That's the story of the ball game. They've been able to keep him in the pocket and force him to play the way that Tampa Bay has wanted him to play. No big runs, no big plays down the field. This defense doing a job.
Third down and 2. Johnson fires, and he's got Jurevicius. Huge game for Joe Jurevicius out to midfield.
Brad Johnson was telling me yesterday that he really loves throwing the ball to Joe Jurevicius. And it's obvious here today, he is such a big physical guy that you can put the ball in a lot of different places, and he's the type of receiver that can go up and make that catch. And he's also easy to spot when you're throwing the ball over the middle of the field. You see here, there's nobody in there. And sometimes as a quarterback, you get linemen in your face, but Joe Jurevicius, because of his size, is easy to spot.
6 catches today, 70 yards, 2 touchdowns for Jurevicius. And that one got away from Brad Johnson. McCardell was the closest to it, but looked like that slipped out.
I think that's the worst throw we've seen of Brad today. He hasn't thrown many like that.
You know, one thing that John Gruden has done a great job of today is with this protection. He has decided that he is not going to allow his backs to be in a position to have to pick up these great pass-rushing outside linebackers, Sam Rogers and John Theory. So the only time the backs are blocking is when they're blocking to the tight end side, which gives them a little more time, and Brad Johnson a little more time, consequently.
Did you say witness protection?
I don't know what I said. I'm just up here yapping.
Second down and 10. McBurrows came up to make the hit. Hits Pittman after a gain of 4.
And I think you've got to give John Gruden credit. He continues to try to run the football even when they don't have much success with it. And it's been a constant theme this season how badly he wants to run the ball. And you touched on it a little bit earlier, Chris. John said, I would love to run the ball on first down and see second and 5 and run the ball again. And that's what he did, and he got accustomed to doing there when he was at Oakland. But he has faced a lot of long down situations, and he's got another one here.
The only team that runs the ball worse than Tampa Bay this season, the Chicago Bears. Third down and 6. Hey, it's Joe Jurevicius inside the 30. All season highs for Jurevicius. 7 catches, 88 yards.
Well, the good news for the Bucs is we have not called Kenyatta Walker's name very much at all today, which means he's doing a good job on the outside against Patrick Kearney, a great pass rusher. Of course, he was banged up in the first half, and Brad Johnson also working against the cornerback that has been banged up, Ray Buchanan. When you have a veteran quarterback, Troy, he knows where there's those vulnerabilities.
Little change up at the running back position, a gain of 4. See Jurevicius limping around. He's got leg injuries and yet still able to carve up this Atlanta secondary for season highs all across the board.
Yeah, and that's another reason why he hasn't played more in recent weeks is because he's not completely healed from the leg injuries that he suffered earlier in the season.
Had a knee, he sprained his ankle earlier in this game. The Falcons wouldn't believe it. Pittman, back to the line of scrimmage, he got a yard.
And really, to a point in the ball game now where this Falcons defense just has to make a play. It looks like Michael Pittman's helmet got knocked off of him on that run, and obviously a dangerous situation.
Well, he's down and will get medical attention as his helmet came off, and he might have suffered a hit after he lost his headgear. Got a knee to the head, and he gets attention here in the third quarter.
So, how was Florida?
Nice.
A lot of pretty girls on the beach?
Yep.
Probably wearing bikinis, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Pretty girls in bikinis.
Right now, fly Southwest Airlines for just $39 to $99 each way when you purchase by December 12th. So get packing.
You are now free to move about the country.
With its new available Power Stroke diesel and 5-speed automatic torque shift transmission that generates 560 pound-feet of torque and 325 horsepower, the Ford F-Series Super Duty pulls faster and easier than any other diesel pickup. Ford F-Series, the best-selling truck on the planet.
Well, guess that settles that.
Yep.
It's built Ford tough.
Happy birthday, sweetheart.
Wow.
Yeah, I knew you'd like chocolate cake.
Yes, I will marry you.
What?
I love it.
Oh, wow.
I'm engaged.
We're engaged.
I'm so surprised.
And I'm like, I'm the one that's surprised.
How long have you been dating?
2 weeks.
Life is best told over a great tasting Miller Lite at a place called Miller Time.
Hold on. She's excited.
Okay, hi, Mom.
This telecast is copyrighted by the NFL for the private use of our audience. Any other use of this telecast or of any pictures, descriptions, or accounts of the game without the NFL's consent is prohibited.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Miller Lite. Life is best told at a place called Miller Time.
It's a third down for Tampa Bay. The Bucs leading 21-3. Little bunch formation to the near side. Johnson looks that way. Now looks left. Now down the middle. McCardell is overthrown. But again, the key, Brad Johnson has had forever to stand back there and find receivers.
We've seen Keith Brookings struggle in man-to-man coverage. That time, Chris Draft had Keyshawn Johnson on this matchup zone across the field and got a little help from the umpire, which allowed him to lock up. That's where Brad Johnson was looking to begin that play.
It'll be a 42-yard try for Martin Gramatica. More misses this season than in any other. He's missed seven times. My aim is true. 24-3. A lead of 21 points. Brad Johnson and the Bucs offense doing it in the second half.
Excuse me.
I'm thinking of a number between 1 and
37. It's 37.
It's a nice hat.
Thank you.
Look, you just saw Lady in half without any repercussion.
Whoa.
Are you Italian?
No.
No.
Flaming lips. You're up.
Introducing the Media Center PC from HP, powered by the Intel Pentium 4 processor. Your TV, music, photos, and videos, all living happily together inside one powerful home computer with the Intel Pentium 4 processor. Call or visit one of these retailers.
I need a car. No, a convertible, a red one, with under 15,000 miles.
AutoTrader.com. With 2 million new or used cars, you can find the one you really want. And with millions of shoppers, you can sell the one you already have. It's the ultimate automotive classified site. AutoTrader.com. Your car is waiting.
Looking for laughs on Sunday night?
Oh, help, please!
Don't struggle. You'll only sink faster.
Don't miss the best comedies on television. The Simpsons, King of the Hill, Malcolm, and Andy Richter.
I had to end things with Irina.
So she was pretty mad, huh?
It was pretty painful.
It all starts at 8, 7 Central tonight on Fox.
That Warren Sapp defense is ready to head back to work. 24-3, Tampa Bay on top, under 10 to play in the third quarter. Gramatica gets that little leg into the ball, and Rossum takes it from inside the five. They try a reverse. Ivy was there to sniff it out. Good play. And well covered by Tampa Bay. Phillips eventually with a tackle. Let's look back on the season for Atlanta. You can make the case with a couple of breaks. They could have started the season 2-0, but they started 0-2. Vick was hurt in the loss to Tampa Bay on the hit by Simeon Rice. A big comeback by Atlanta ends in a tie in Pittsburgh. And then Vick wows the Vikings, not only in the overtime, but that entire game last week with 173 yards, but not much today. And now the test changes for Mike Vick. Down by 21 points, he overshoots Crumpler. I mean, this is now a different situation, Troy, for Mike Vick. Down by 21 points in a spot where you expect him to throw the ball more.
Well, that's exactly right. And now is when he's going to have to start being able to throw the ball. And you can see he has time here to throw the football, and there were probably some lanes that if the game were a little closer, he would have tried to take them. But he's got to be able to make some plays with his arm if they're going to have a chance to get back into this game.
Against Tampa Bay, and in Mike Vick's defense, Kurt Warner, when healthy, quote-unquote, was not good against Tampa Bay. Brett Favre was awful against the Buccaneers a couple of weeks back. Vick is struggling, setting up a screen to dunk it. Warren Sapp was the first to get out there and make a hit. Gain of 6 on the play.
I mean, that's really remarkable. Warren Sapp was on the far side of the field reading that screen, sprints all the way across the field. He comes up the field working the pass rush, sees the screen. Now watch the speed for a guy that weighs, I'm going to give him 300. How about 300?
I think at least 300. And for the way that he can move, it's just unbelievable the speed for a man that big. Third and three. Jefferson. Bring it out for the Falcons.
I think what happens is when you start setting Michael Vick up in the middle of the pocket, then he becomes just like a pocket passer. I still think that the Falcons have to try to move him outside, move the pocket some, because this Tampa Bay defense is as good as anybody in the league when they know where the quarterback is going to be, of going after him and getting to him.
I don't think they care if he's in the pocket throwing the ball.
No, I don't think they do either, Chris. Chris Moore. Terrific hang time. 4-6. And the fair catch by Carl Williams. Brad Johnson. Back to the field.
Ford Focus. It has a European tuned suspension for exceptional maneuverability and control. That's why Automobile Magazine calls it the best small car to drive. So don't be surprised if you can handle whatever the road throws at you. Ford Focus.
Performances by Justin Timberlake, Avril Lavigne, Nelly, Creed, Faith Hill. Plus appearances by Cher, Michael Jackson, and more. Live, Cedric the Entertainer hosts the 2002 Billboard Music Awards at 8, 7 Central, Fox Monday.
In many respects, a must-win for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers today. You look at their offensive leaders. Why is it a must-win? They're in first place, but a loss would place them behind Atlanta in the NFC South. You look at the upcoming schedule, outside of at Detroit next week for Tampa Bay, they host Pittsburgh, and then they're at Chicago in what figures to be another cold weather game as they try to stay at the top of the playoff seeding, the number two right now, to host at least one playoff game. On first down, give us to Stecker, and Aaron moves it forward for two.
Well, what a fantastic day it's been for Brad Johnson. I have no idea what his quarterback rating is, but it has to be astronomical. And I'm sure Brad, after the game, is going to tell you, yes, my receivers had a very good day, but the key really has been the play of this offensive line. When these two teams met earlier in the season, he was knocked around continually during the course of the day. No hurries, and the only sack he had was when he got his foot stepped on and tripped. There's been no pressure on Brad Johnson all day.
Second down and eight, play action. That's the fullback, Cook.
Johnson's pass
forced out of bounds for three. You want to know what his quarterback rating is? 141.3.
That's not bad. What's perfection? 158?
158, I believe. But he's doing it again. This offensive line is doing it against a defense that came into this game ranked second in quarterback sacks at 39. And they picked a good time. This offensive line for Tampa Bay picked a good game in order to protect him, because Brad was still sore from last week's game against New Orleans. So his body was not equipped coming into this game to take more pounding than what he'd already had.
Third down and five. Johnson floats it. Judd, that's just another catch. And another Tampa Bay first down. Now they're going to flag Buchanan for firing the football at Jurevicius.
Here's a look at the offensive line. Kenyatta Walker once again giving Brad time to throw the football, and this is a good throw. It's a good location. Again, talking about the size of Jurevicius, but Brad Johnson puts it up high where only he can get it. You see Ray Buchanan, and again, you wonder how much that leg is bothering him, not keeping better coverage on Jurevicius.
Oh, this is a really a tough day for Ray Buchanan. I think you have to give him a lot of credit just for showing up. He couldn't even run in pregame warm-up, went in and got it shot up, and has been playing as hard as he can.
Defense, number 33, this penalty is declined. Unsportsmanlike conduct, taunting, number 34, defense, 15-yard penalty, automatic.
Jurevicius gave Buchanan a little something extra at the end of the play, laid the ball down, and Buchanan threw it at him.
Yeah, Jurevicius is going to taunt him a little bit first, give him the spinning ball right in his face, and Buchanan reacted and got the flag.
They always catch the second guy.
That moves the ball just shy of the Atlanta 35. Talking on the public address system as the snap is made and the catch is made by Dudley. What a throw by Johnson. Unconscious.
Brad Johnson is absolutely on fire today, and you know when you get into a groove, everything comes easy. He pumps the safety, gets him working to his right, comes back to Dudley in the seam. Fits it in there before the corner. Actually, the safety, McBurrows, is able to get back over there to make a play on that, but Brad Johnson right now is seeing the field awfully well.
And I thought the key was Brad's pumping the other way, getting the safety to slide that way, leaving it open for Dudley.
First down and goal. All stop. Still going, and they'll mark him near the three. Second down and goal.
I know a lot of teams don't want to have to go to Green Bay for a playoff game, but I'm not sure anybody wants to come to Tampa Bay either, except for that opening day loss against the New Orleans Saints. This football team in this stadium has just been tremendous.
And look at the other side of it. Tampa Bay in their history, 0-6 on the road in the playoffs. They've lost 13 straight overall in Green Bay. They've lost their last two playoff games in Philly by a total of 52-12. Wouldn't this group love to stay home, at least for the first game? Second down and goal. Back in the end zone, Bolden had a shot at a pick. Dudley couldn't get to it either, and it's third and goal.
Good idea there. Brad Johnson gives Dudley an opportunity, tries to throw it up high, let Dudley go up over the top. Bolden there to make a play, and you know, when you're having days like this as a quarterback, this is when it really gets fun. You get into a rhythm, much like a basketball player does when you're shooting baskets, and you can throw anything up and it goes in. And it's the same way for a quarterback, and today, Brad Johnson has gotten into that kind of groove.
Atlanta defense would like a stop. They'd love a turnover. Keyshawn, incomplete. Well covered by Buchanan. That'll bring up fourth down and bring Gramatica onto the field.
And that time, instead of Ray Buchanan throwing the football at him, he actually helped Keyshawn Johnson up.
Boy, it's been a tough day for Ray Buchanan, but that is perfect. And Keyshawn said, I don't need your help. But that's the highest we've seen Ray jump all day, I think, because of the strained abdomen. They've been trying to work him high today, force him to stretch up. That time he got off the ground to make a play.
21-yard try is drilled by Gramatica. He's hit from 42, he's hit from 21. The offense rolling today under John Gruden. That's a bad sign for the rest of the NFC here in December.
Mr. Frodo?
The ring's getting heavier, Sam.
A new power is rising.
It is an army bred to destroy the world of men.
How did it come to this?
Your friends are with you, Aragorn.
The defenses have to hold.
They will hold.
The Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers, rated PG-13, starts Wednesday, December 18th.
It used to be business was conducted face-to-face, and people were helpful. It was known as common courtesy. At Siebel, we make application software that lets you once again give your customers personalized service. It's made a real difference in a lot of successful companies. It could make one in yours. Siebel, good service is good business.
Feast your eyes on the new fajita grilled stuffed burrito from Taco Bell. Sizzling strips of marinated steak and grilled veggies. All the great fajita flavors now wrapped to go in a grilled tortilla.
Ooh, fajitas.
Ooh, fajitas.
Taste the new fajita grilled stuffed burrito and think outside the bun.
Why do I rent from Enterprise? For more cargo room. More people room. Or more headroom. Enterprise. So easy, it's like having a second car. Or third.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Southwest Airlines, proud sponsor of the NFL and official airline of Super Bowl 37, by Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers, in theaters December 18th, rated PG-13, by Lycos, explore all the world you live in, Lycos, search on, and by Ford, the best-selling trucks are built Ford tough.
That could be St. Pete Beach, that could be Madeira Beach, that could be Reddington Beach.
Clearwater.
Clearwater Beach. Mike Vick with his hands on his hips wondering what the heck has happened today here in Tampa, Florida. Alan Wasson. Just across the 25, brought down at the 26. See if the Falcons can get anything going on offense after the timeout.
Ever notice how many Ford trucks you see out there? Is it because they're so tough? Is it payload? Horsepower? Towing? Their off-road capabilities? The Triton engines? Lasting durability? Or is it all those things that have made Ford F-Series the best-selling truck for 25 straight years? Leadership has no boundaries when you're built Ford tough.
Tiki, your mom's gonna love these.
Hey, take a check.
I'm just gonna need some ID. Okay. How do I know this is you? Because it looks just like him.
But it's me.
Okay. But it looks like him. This says that you were born...
1975.
Okay. But it could still be him.
Next time, use the Visa check card instead of checks. It'll get you in, out, and on with life.
So, are you guys related?
Hey, we gotta get going. I'll put the hors d'oeuvres in the car. Just grab my brother's gift, okay? You forgot my brother's gift.
No. I didn't forget. It's at Circuit City.
We're gonna pick it up on the way.
Forget. I didn't forget.
You forgot. That's why with Express Pickup, you can order gifts online and pick up within minutes. It's that fast. Circuit City, we're with you.
Wow, that was fast.
I have no idea.
What?
I'm a player in the National Football League.
But that is not who I am.
I'm a member of a community.
Dedicated to making a difference
in people's lives.
I'm a player in the National Football League.
Hey, look at the NFC South. Tampa Bay with a record of 9-3-0. Atlanta right behind them, but in trouble here today. And then you look at the schedules. And New Orleans will play at Baltimore later, but the toughest schedule the rest of the way in the division belongs to Tampa Bay.
Yeah, but remember, New Orleans has two wins against Tampa Bay, so any tie in the division would go to New Orleans with the first tiebreaker, and probably their toughest game is today at Baltimore.
Just so you know, Atlanta 2-0 against New Orleans this season. Vick buying time and then throws it up for grabs. Finneran had better position then Rondé Barber, but could not make the catch. Let's go down to Pam Oliver.
Well, Joe, I've been watching Mike Vick most of the game, and boy, his demeanor certainly doesn't change. I've yet to see him really show any frustration on the sideline with the team trailing 27-3. He comes off the field, takes a seat on the same spot at the bench, and just chill. I've seen him clap his hands a couple of times in an effort to fire himself up, and if anybody can change a game, it's Vick, and boy, the Falcons sure need his magic.
Second down and 10. Thank you, Pam. See the Giants with their lead at Washington, 17-6. Vick hit from behind. Spires.
And the thing to remember, Greg Spires right here, is that the Tampa Bay Buccaneers are bringing pressure with only four guys. They're bringing their four defensive linemen. That time Spires working against Todd Weiner comes around the backside, and Michael Vick, when you're playing this defense, you cannot hold on to the football, and it hurts him because they got to make some plays down the field, which means he has to hold it, and when you hold it, you're going to take some hits.
Sacked twice today, 29 times this season. Third down and 16. Vick down the middle of the field, and there were three Tampa Bay defenders around Gaylor. McFarland had pressure as Vick dropped back, and it's another three and out.
And Shelton Quarles again down the middle of the field. You talk about the Tampa 2 defense, and what it is essentially is you have guys all the way across the field, and then your middle linebacker is going to run deep to try and cover the hole in that 2 defense that they have back there. Shelton Quarles just getting way down the field to make another play.
This Falcons offense does not even have 100 yards of offense yet today.
Beautiful punt by Moore. He's been one of the highlights for Atlanta today. That's a bad sign. Carl Williams, good return. Penalty flag on the return as Williams is down inside the Atlanta 45.
And I thought a big reason why Tampa Bay lost last week to the New Orleans Saints was the play of their special teams, especially to start the second half. They gave up a big kickoff return, then fumbled the ball on the ensuing kickoff return that they had, and just gave all the momentum to the Saints. And yet today in this ball game, the special teams crew for the Bucs has been pretty dominant.
During the return of the kick, illegal block in the back, receiving team number 38. 10-yard penalty, first down.
That's Howell, John Howell is flagged for the infraction. Coming up after football, it's the Sports Illustrated Sportsman of the Year Award here on Fox. Howie Long will host it, a one-hour special to announce the Sports Illustrated Sportsman of the Year with highlights of the greatest sports moments of the past year. Sports Illustrated Sportsman of the Year Show 2002 coming up after football here on Fox.
That Howie gets around, doesn't he?
Yeah. Busy. Only one punt over the last six possessions, and that's all stopped. And the running game has been better today for Tampa as Allstop picked up 10. It's a first down.
Well, I think this is the time when if you're going to run the football, it really plays right into the hands of Mike Allstop. Roman Oben there collapsing the defensive end, and it gives him a lane to run the football. But that's really when Mike Allstott is at his best. When you've got a big lead, you want to try to take some time off the clock, and then he can start just trying to wear down the defense.
This is a good Atlanta defense. 15th in the league overall. But really hurt because of that huge day in Pittsburgh. The Steelers ran up and down the field on them. Other than that, they've been tough. Allstott pushes the pile all the way to the 50, a gain of 5.
We said earlier that John Gruden would love to have an opportunity to run the football on first down and then have it be second and 5. Well, he got his wish. It's second and 5.
And one of the things that John Gruden has done so well this year is manage the game. When they get their leads, he doesn't have a huge ego of an offensive coordinator. He's still the head coach, so he's willing to go out, play a little small ball, hand the thing off. Even if you have to punt it every once in a while, it's no big deal. When you have this kind of defense, just don't make the big mistakes on offense, and you're going to win the football game.
Reality bites on Mike Vick today. Reality is this Tampa defense is tremendous. On an end around Carl Williams, second time they've tried that today, and Williams got about half a yard.
Yeah, Sam Rogers, outside linebacker, does a great job of seeing that. Brad Johnson trying to get in there and make the block, but He's not going to block Sam Rogers.
Now, do you guys have like a quarterback blocking school?
Just go to the ground. He did more than you're supposed to do. He actually made contact. Supposed to stumble or something before you get there.
He got out there and looked like he might throw a block before he got drilled to the ground.
Third down and a long three. Complete. Well played by Bolden. Came around Keyshawn Johnson, who's looking for a flag and won't get it. That's one of the few times today that Brad Johnson has been on the ground.
It's interesting, though, that for Brad Johnson to have this huge day today and Keyshawn Johnson not really a big part of it. It's been more of Keenan McCardell and Joe Juravicius.
Rare punt from Tom Tupa with a minute 38 remaining in the third quarter. Fair catch called for and made by Alan Rossum. Punt of 36 yards. Well, next week we will have a fun one late in the day. It'll be Brett Favre taking his Green Bay Packers out to San Francisco for a battle against the 49ers. Seating certainly on the line when these two hook up next Sunday at 4 Eastern right here on Fox.
Well, that one should be a good game. Of course, you got Green Bay and Minnesota tonight. San Francisco's in a close ball game as we speak with Dallas, but that game next week, a lot of playoff implications on the line then.
Yeah, there really are, and you've got to think, as evenly matched as these teams are in the NFC, the team that comes away with home field advantage will have a real advantage in the playoffs.
From their own 14, Vick throws. And a rare completion, he gets his big tight end, Reggie Kelly. Just so you know, the Tampa Bay defense held Vick to 1 yard rushing the first time they met. They've allowed a total of 84 yards rushing by opposing quarterbacks. And today, Michael Vick has rushed for only 15 yards. So they have done it yet again in holding a quarterback, keeping him under control. And there's Monty Kiffin, the outstanding defensive coordinator. Vick, nowhere to run downfield. Penalty flag, and Vick flips it up into the air, and Finneran can't get it on the tip. But it's a hold against Atlanta.
Yeah, and how about yesterday, Monty Kiffin, when we were talking with him, and he said, you know, I've been playing in the NFC Central against Green Bay and Brett Favre and having to face him twice a year, and he finally started to slow down, and then they realigned the divisions, and now we're in the South with Atlanta.
Holding, offense, number 70, 10-yard penalty, repeat, first down.
And now we're having to face Michael Vick and the problems that he possesses, and he Monty Kiffin didn't get a lot of sleep this week.
Yeah, and he's still mad at John Butler, the general manager for San Diego, for making that trade.
That's right.
He said, you know, I finally get rid of Brett Favre, and now I get Michael Vick, but so far he has had Michael Vick's number. They've dominated Vick in these two games.
They've dominated Favre and Vick this season. Christian on first and 20, and right in the middle, it's Nate Webster.
Christian, the ball carrier.
Gain of only one.
Yeah, Nate Webster, he was the guy who was projected to play middle linebacker in place of Jamie Duncan, and he had some problems with his shoulders, had surgery on those in the offseason, missed some camps. They put Shelton Quarles in there at middle linebacker. Of course, he's gone on to have a great season, and Nate Webster, however, is continued to be the backup at that position.
Quarles comes out, Webster in. Only 3 seconds left in the third quarter. Vick steps up, has his man Gaylor wide open. Down inside the 35, and that's how the third quarter will come to a close. The biggest offensive play of the day from the Atlanta Falcons. Out of the left hand of Mike Vick, into the arms of Trevor Gaylor. The end of the third quarter, 27-3 Tampa Bay. The NFL on Fox will continue after a word from your local Fox station.
You're watching the NFL on Fox.
It only happens once a year. Toyotathon 03. This year-end tradition features incredible values on your favorite Toyota cars. See your Toyota dealer now for great year-end deals on Camry. Like financing as low as 0.0% APR on all 2003 Camry models. Or lease a 2003 Camry LE for $239 a month for 39 months with $1,738 due at signing. Toyotathon 03. Don't miss it. See your Toyota dealer today.
Today to the Mercedes-Benz year-end celebration, offering more models than ever. Going on now at your Mercedes-Benz dealer.
Now the time has come.
The year-end wrap-up event ends soon. The time to see your local Southern Ford dealer is now. Time runs out on the year-end wrap-up event soon. Visit your local Southern Ford dealer now.
I'm Lloyd Towers. Happy holidays from Fox 13.
Welcome back for the start of the fourth quarter. Joe Buck, Troy Aikman, Chris Collinsworth, Pam Oliver, Richie Zients, our producer, Artie Kempner, our director. It's a first down for Atlanta, and the ball inside the Tampa Bay 35. Vick's quarterback rating this season, 89.1 against every team other than Tampa Bay, 45.6 against the Bucs. Hand off is to Duncan. And TJ is wrapped up after a game of a couple.
By number 52, Nate Webster.
Let's look at the playoff picture around the NFC. The division leaders on your left. And it appears at least that Tampa Bay will stay in that column. The wild card leaders with commanding leads over the group on the far right, still alive, barely breathing, the Giants, Cowboys, Redskins, and Rams.
I believe the Giants are winning today, so they will stay alive and nobody will be clinching as long as they're in it.
Second down and eight. Duckett. Good tackle by Barber. Gain of four.
Watch Travis Claridge on this play. He's going to get Warren Sapp with his back turned on him and just going to bear hug him. Turn him around, just grab, just go hold him, get him into full Nelson. Here comes the reverse. And Sapp's going to go right after the referee since the play's over. You got to be kidding me.
Hey, what are you watching?
Come on.
Third down and four. Boy, what a jump by Spires. Picked off. Penalty flag on the play. Brooks in for the score, but will check the marker.
And remember, Derek Brooks already has three interceptions returned for a touchdown. No linebacker in the history of the NFL has ever done that. This would be his fourth, but I'm afraid there's going to be an offside, and it probably will come back.
It looked like Spires, Troy, came across too early.
Yeah, it was. It was Greg Spires, the left defensive end. He got a jump as soon as he came off the ball.
Offside.
The official was
defense,
throwing the flag.
Number 94 in the neutral zone at the snap. 5-yard penalty.
At the bottom of the screen, you'll see he's going to take off a little early. There it is. Got into the neutral zone prior to the ball being snapped, and that's unfortunate for Derek Brooks.
5-yard penalty will result in a first down.
So a first down for Atlanta after the penalty on Spires.
And Derek Brooks is coming out of the game. I think he's going to go over and take a seat on the bench and see if he can't get his air back.
Greg Spires is going to get hit hard in the kangaroo court this week, too.
Four touchdowns overall for Derrick Brooks. And it's a first down for Atlanta at the Tampa Bay 22. Play action. Vick flips it. Kozlowski, penalty flag. Al Singleton had his hands all over Kozlowski, and the flag was thrown.
Well, that was an easy one, too, because he was all over him, and official right there to make the call.
Pass interference, defense, number 51. The ball be spotted at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
He never even turns around. You see him sling Kozlowski when he came off the line of scrimmage. Then once he realized it was passed, tried getting back into coverage. Had his hands all over Kozlowski as the ball got there.
And when you have that guy in the ball game, Michael Vick, you punch one in here, make it a 27-10 game, really anything can still happen.
But don't you know the Tampa defense would love to beat their chest after this game and say, we didn't let Vick get the Falcons into the end zone. Duckett running right, brought down behind the line of scrimmage. Nate Webster. Loss of three.
Really just not much of a living to be made against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers trying to run to the outside. And T.J. Duckett's a big, strong, physical guy. Had some success last week against Minnesota running outside, but Minnesota's defense is not the Tampa Bay defense.
Well, and the other thing that's hurt Atlanta is they don't have Warrick Dunn, and so T.J. Duckett is just a pure straight-ahead runner, and they don't have the receiving threat in the backfield that they have when they have Dunn in the game.
Out after spraining his right ankle last week in the first quarter. Vick over the middle. Pass is caught by Kelly. It'll be third down. The ball just shy of the five, and Vick gets up after taking a big hit.
And you see him shaking his head, and I think he's, for the hits that he's taken, the frustration that he's gone through, you can see it's starting to affect him. It's starting to get into his head a little bit, and there's a pretty good shot right there. And if you remember correctly, he was sick during the week, missed Wednesday's practice, and he said last night that he was feeling good, but I don't know how good he's feeling right now.
I'll tell you, that could have been helmet-to-helmet contact on that one as well, and an automatic first down.
Third and three. Looking right all the way, and touchdown Crumpler. Mike Vick gets his 11th touchdown of the season, and it's Crumpler who hauls in his fourth.
Well, Mike Vick has hung in here today, and he found what I think is his best receiving threat at the tight end position, Algie Crumpler. Reggie Kelly is a good blocking tight end, but when it comes to making catches, Algie Crumpler is just a much better player.
After initially asking the sideline if they should go for two, they're going to line up and try for the extra point.
That's the right decision. Takes you down 17, two touchdowns, a field goal.
A 27-10 lead for Tampa Bay. And for the first time today, Mike Vick leads the Falcons into the Buccaneer end zone.
Look, Roy, Jimmy's emailed us pictures from camp.
Way to go, Jimmy. That's my boy.
Hey, it's a picture from Jimmy.
Dude, we have to go to camp next year.
Looking for more expressive email? Introducing MSN 8. It's our best version of MSN yet with more exciting email. Switching is easy, and if you call now, you get 2 months free when you sign up. Find out why it's better with the butterfly. Call 866-TRY-MSN-8 today.
Welcome to the kingdom.
Are we there yet?
No.
Are we there yet?
No.
Simpsons Talking Watches, now only at Burger King. Just $2.39 each with the purchase of any value meal.
Cool your jets, man.
Mmm, burger.
Collect all four. And our big double cheeseburger is just 99 cents. With two slices of melted cheese and two juicy flame-broiled patties. More beef than a big and tasty. Hurry, offers end soon.
Can you keep a secret? Look what
what I bought Mommy for Christmas. Your mom gave me you? Yes, she did.
This holiday, how do you thank your wife for the best Christmas ever? A K Jewelers 3-stone diamond necklace with free gift would be a great start. And you can be assured of two things. First, that every K diamond is hand-selected for exceptional beauty. And second, that she'll absolutely love it.
A little angel assured me you'd love this.
The little angel was right.
Every kiss begins with K.
Bucs NFL Sunday is brought to you by K Jewelers. This holiday season, shop K Jewelers. Every kiss begins with K. By Burger King. Get a Simpsons talking watch for just $2.39 with the purchase of any value meal. By new MSN8. It's better with the butterfly. MSN8 more useful every day. And by Sprint. Introducing PCS Vision. Clearly a whole new way to look at wireless.
One singular sensation to another. Mike Vick. Perfect on that drive, an eight-play drive, and Vick was 5 for 5 for 81 yards. 86-yard drive in all. And the first touchdown of the day for Atlanta. That's Stecker. Tripped up as he got to the 20, and he falls forward out to the 23. We'll talk more about Vick, and boys, there's plenty to say about Mike Vick before the end of this game and where this game puts him. Everybody talking about the most valuable player award coming in. His first real test here in the month of December, taking on the Tampa Bay defense. I guess we'll save that for the next time Atlanta has the ball, but I know, Troy, you have a lot of thoughts on where Mike Vick is in his young NFL career.
Well, I think the first thing to remember is that a lot of these people that were saying all this last week about him being MVP and his progression probably had not even seen him play other than watching the highlights each Sunday night. But today's one of those days that a young quarterback goes through, and he's going to be a great one. But I think maybe they put the tag on him a little bit too early.
Pittman running right. Michael, a good run. And a first down.
Well, Michael Pittman having one of his better games. He had the big pass reception earlier, and now getting to the outside, you have Allstott, who's able to pound you between the tackles late in the ball game, and then Pittman can gouge you to the outside, and that's really what they had been hoping for when they signed Pittman to the big contract, but it just hasn't worked that way this year.
Pittman at a 4.3 average today, came in at 3.4. First down, Tampa. Running over the left side. Mike Allstott won't go down. Wow. Down to the 30. Buchanan lost his helmet. And Allstott reminding everyone that he is the A-Train.
Well, that's his second big run today. The first one was because he was able to get outside of containment. On this one, for one of the few times this year, there is a hole up inside. The line does a good job of clearing out a little path, and that's really all that Mike Allstott needs. I mean, he's got great balance. You see him there, he ricochets off people. Once he gets going in a straight line, he's a hard man to get down on the ground.
He might kill the secondary from the Falcons. Keon Carpenter got completely run over. Ray Buchanan got his helmet knocked off as he's running down the field. What a run by Allstott.
Broke four tackles and a helmet. First down. Allstott again. A gain of one. Let's go to Los Angeles. Check in with James Brown for a game break.
All right, Joe, take a look. The Dallas defense blocked the punt. Emmitt Smith capitalized on that with a 5-yard TD run. 13-10 Dallas. That in the fourth. And Tiki Barber, after a Champ Bailey fumbled punt return, takes it 1 yard to pay dirt. It is now 24-14 Giants. That in the fourth as well. Back to Joe Buck.
Did they go for two?
I think they've learned their lesson. Trying to stay alive are the New York Giants. You never know. Trying to get down the field and get into the end zone, primarily with the running game of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, and this time it's Pittman after two straight from Allstott. And Pittman on second down picks up three.
Not by draft.
People always ask the question, why not Mike Allstott and Michael Pittman in the same backfield? And as good a runner as Mike Allstott is, and as powerful as he is with the football in his hands, it really doesn't translate when he's blocking. It's very hard for me to explain, but he doesn't have the same sort of explosion when he's blocking that he does when he has that ball and dunks his shoulder and running over people.
Tough to make the highlight rule making a block.
That may may have something to do with it.
Third down six. Johnson pumps and throws. McCardell all alone. Touchdown. Going to hope that this game never ends. Keenan McCardell, you see him right here. He jumps up inside. Brad lays it out there, and Keenan McCardell, who had a big game last week, having a big game again today.
And McCardell really sold that corner fake, and Ashley Ambrose just froze.
34-10. Out of the hand of Brad Johnson. He's had guys open. He's had time to throw. He has had a huge day.
Yeah, ever since I got this, I feel...
stronger, faster?
Yeah, I'm doing this, doing that. Bing, bing, bang. This thing has turned me into... what's the word?
Want a more powerful phone? Switch to Sprint and get unlimited PCS vision, unlimited night and weekend minutes, and 300 anytime minutes. And now, at Sprint stores, get great deals instantly on PCS phones with full-color screens.
So you just go around in your costume helping people?
And I do what I can.
PCS from Sprint. Clearly, the phone to give or get.
Happy anniversary, honey.
Yeah, happy anniversary.
There's something I gotta do.
Oh, yeah? What?
I love this woman! I love her!
What are you doing? Stop!
Okay, then I guess... this will have to do.
Oh, my God. I love this man. I love him. I love him. I love him.
These people are getting answers to the most important questions they'll ever ask. Questions about their health. They're finding those answers in a single place. WebMD. 16 million people come to WebMD every month. They find vital information that used to be scattered in 100 locations, now all in one place. The place America comes for healthcare answers. A place called WebMD.
Only Remington has the most cutting blades, the fastest cutting speed, and the most total floating head action. How important is that? Well, how important is a close, comfortable shave? Remington, what a great shave feels like.
Coming in ranked 31st in the NFL with their running game. Gruden took his second run this week at Ricky Waters, bringing him in, and two other unnamed running backs trying to infuse a little life to the running game for the Buccaneers, who today have piled up 118 yards on the ground. That has only helped the day for Brad Johnson. Rossum gets to the 20, and he's brought down at the 23. I don't know if the Buccaneers spend more time game planning for the Atlanta Falcons or watching the Falcons celebrate from one end zone to the next as they rough it up out near the 25-yard line, but no penalty flags are thrown. Or if they spend more time looking at celebrations. Falcons have been passing the magic. Brad Johnson has been passing magic around all day. Ah! 34-10, Buccaneers.
Turn here.
Let's go.
Sure, just hop in. It's easy. What could go wrong?
The Hyundai Santa Fe, with America's best warranty. When you take things in stride, you win.
His name is Henry, Clay Henry. He's a fireman and a Jared fan from Subway.
He got real big on burgers and fries. Now he's down to a smaller size.
Gets his mite from his veggie delight. Great taste each day from his local Subway.
Looking and feeling better and enjoying the great taste of Subway's low-fat sweet onion chicken teriyaki. No wonder everyone wants to be more like Clay Henry.
Subway, eat fresh.
taste that won't fill you up and never let you down. Make it a Bud Light.
Favre and the Packers. Owens and the Niners. It's a Fox NFL Sunday doubleheader next week.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Bud Light. For the great taste that won't fill you up and never lets you down, make it a Bud Light.
A first down handoff to Duckett. Not done. 2 yards, that's it. Well, we came in talking about Mike Vick and about the Tampa Bay defense. The Tampa Bay defense has done their usual thing. The Tampa Bay offense has shredded a pretty good 3-4 defense for Atlanta. A 34-10 score. And during the break, you had the Tampa Bay defensive front dancing to the music, waving their arms around. Well, that's a bad sign if you're Mike Vick or any other quarterback in the NFL. These guys are coming. Ron Warner in at the left end spot. Duckett. First down. Wow. What a hit he laid on John Howell, who's filling in for the injured John Lynch, who strained his neck early in this game.
Well, here's TJ Duckett, and again, once he gets going downhill, he's tough to bring down as well. We talked about Allstott. And
gain of 13.
He's been a nice changeup, and Warrick Dunn hasn't been able to play, but he's been a nice changeup this season when you combine his skills along with Warrick Dunn's when they're in the game. Whoa. That was a shot.
We're keeping the ball out of the hands of Mike Vick, putting it in the hands of Duckett, who gets two.
You know, Joe, you talked about this defensive front and them getting cranked up and going after the quarterback, and the guy responsible for getting them that way is defensive line coach Rod Marinelli, and he's done a fabulous job with Anthony McFarland as well as Warren Sapp, and their play is well documented, but his current pupil has been Simeon Rice, and last year when he came into this system, he really did not know what it took to be a professional and play at a constant high level, and he credits Rod Marinelli for the job that he's done in showing him the way and getting him ready to play.
Vietnam veteran is Marinelli. These players swear by him. Vick throws, and it's behind Christian. You mentioned Simeon Rice, who came into this game with 5 consecutive games with 2 or more sacks for an NFL record. He has been shut out today.
Well, and Simeon Rice, he has never been voted to a Pro Bowl. And it's a little bit surprising because a few years back, he was 2nd in the NFL in sacks. He's leading the league this year in sacks. He's been tremendous. And if he doesn't get voted to the Pro Bowl this year, something's wrong. In fact, we've said it already, he could be the NFL Defensive Player of the Year.
And he really could have had a couple of sacks today, but for some holds by Bob Woodfield.
3rd down and 8. Vick just got rid of it. Too high for Finneran. And Vick ends up on his front after being dumped by Rondé Barber.
And I don't really understand why Mike Vick is still in this ball game. You've got one of the best pass rushing teams in football, and this is just a feeding frenzy for the defense. Anytime you're this far behind, you've got a young quarterback in the game, you're just going to allow him to take shots he really shouldn't be taking.
Yeah, and TJ Duckett, again, the rookie, he misses the blitz from Rondé Barber. That should have been picked up, which would have eliminated the hit on Vick.
Said the biggest difference between college and the NFL is they hit harder at this level.
Let go, let go!
And he's been hit a lot today. Carl Williams with a fair catch made near the 15. 44-yard punt, and Vick will take a break on the bench.
Sorry.
It's okay. Stop! Tim here is on his first date. And his family has some advice. With T-Mobile, families can talk all they want.
Oh. Hello?
Let her win.
Hello?
Tell her she smells nice.
Hello?
Does she come from money?
Hello?
Does she have a sister?
Wrong number.
Families talk free. Additional lines just $10. Only from T-Mobile.
Get more.
There's not a lot of my bed. Nice phone.
gotta get a cordless headset.
What? Funny how the holidays turn even the most serious business people into kids again. Consider Office Depot your toy store, because our people know exactly what business people want for the holidays, and we offer a wide variety of gifts at great prices. Office Depot. What you need to know.
Golf Saturday?
Can't. Tomorrow weekend with the kids.
Looking for the perfect gift that'll brighten everyone's holiday? Just head around the corner for our new gift card from Applebee's.
Eating good in the neighborhood.
Meet Evan, a bachelor construction worker who earns $19,000 a year.
Great hair, great eyes, great body. Mmm!
And meet the 20 women who've traveled to a chateau in France to compete for his heart. Why? They think he's worth $50 million. Now, who would ever give them that idea? Can true love survive a little $50 million lie? Joe Millionaire, a new reality series with a twist.
It's a dream come true. It means so much to me.
That's really twisted. Premiering January 6th on Fox.
How about 22 touchdowns for the season for Brad Johnson? And he will stand on the sideline after throwing four touchdowns today. And it's the Tampa Bay native, Sean King, who got this Buccaneer team to an NFC Championship game in 99, taking over.
Rob Johnson was the number two quarterback, but after some poor performances, Sean King was elevated.
All stop. Penalty flag on the play. King is a native of this area, went to Gibbs High School in St. Pete. And even as recently as a couple of weeks ago, Brad Johnson said, if the fans had their wish, I'd be sitting on the bench and Sean King would be the starter. King's at least moved up to the number two spot.
Yeah, I think the fans remember when he took him to the NFL, or NFC Championship game his rookie season in 1999. And Rob Johnson, Chris was saying,
offense, number 62. This penalty will be assessed half the distance to the goal. Repeat first down.
When he's had his opportunities to come in and play, he just has not performed very well. And John Gruden made the decision to elevate Sean King into the number two position. And Sean King has only attempted one pass so far this season.
All right, you guys want a little trivia here?
Sure.
One other rookie quarterback since 1970 has won a playoff game. Who is it?
Pat Hayden, I think. Who was it?
You're so good.
It was just on TV. They just put the stat up. Pittman gets to the line of scrimmage, then falls backward.
See, I knew that Troy doesn't watch the screen, so I was just testing you to see if you were observing that. Right, yeah.
Is that what it was?
Yeah, I was just giving you a little test.
All right, well, that was... I passed it.
You know, there's a lot of things to look at in this stadium other than our television monitors up here. I like to look at the ship and the crowd and scoreboard. There are a lot of good things going on around here.
It's ridiculous. Get your head out of your board over there and watch the game. Look at all these people up here. We got enough people in the booth to help us do this game?
Troy pays them all, too.
Mr. Aikman, you were the greatest. All stop. What a day he's had. Brought down by Seminole after a gain of 11.
Now, you're like being with a rock star, Buck. I mean, six of these people that are in here are all part of your entourage.
Well, it's the embarrassment that I feel getting out of our little team van at the hotel and just walking into the hotel untouched and unmolested while you're signing Dallas Cowboy helmets. How do these people know that you're in town?
I call and have the papers address it. I mean, I want to show up and at least have people at least feel like they still want me to sign an autograph for them.
Well, you haven't officially retired yet, have you?
I think I have, yeah, 2 years ago.
That's all we need, one more Troy Aikman rumor. Out of way to get it started, Joe.
Third down and 11. Toss to Stecker running right. Aaron Stecker tripped himself, brought down at the 35.
Well, they're all doing that passing the magic deal, and I think when you talk to these Buccaneer players, they didn't like some of the things that were being said by the Falcons this week, that all the rug in Atlanta was being shampooed and it was slippery, and now you're going to see the real Mike Vick and the real Atlanta Falcons, and we're a different team now than we were then. And I think they wanted to throw a little bit of that magic right back over to Atlanta's sideline.
See, a tackle was made on that play. Stecker did not trip himself.
And he got it to the 35, a first down. Under 3.5 to play here in Tampa, Florida. Mike Allstott. Minimal gain, got two. If we don't get the opportunity, we should talk about Mike Vick. And by the way, he told us he wants Mike. So we'll say Mike, although it's easy to get back into Michael Vick. But every team in the NFL would love to have this guy. And you would think the natural selection process would weed out a guy with that kind of speed. Eventually, people would catch up to him, whether it was high school, college, or the NFL. Nobody is catching up to Mike Vick. But he's still got a long way to go to be an MVP and to be a guy that can lead a team in a game like this against this defense to a win. Second down and 8. A yard over the right side.
And I think to comment on that, Joe, there is no question in my mind that Michael Vick is going to be one of the great quarterbacks in this league. But I think what happens is people always want to put that tag on you. And after last week and the big game that he had, immediately people wanted to elevate him to a whole different level. And what people have to realize is that this is a process. And he's going through that right now as a young quarterback. This is his first year to be the starter. And he's getting an opportunity to learn. And this today is one of those learning processes for him. And he'll continue to have those.
2-minute warning. I warn Warren Sapp to stop disrobing at this point.
Fox NFL Sundays brought to you by UPS. What can Brown do for you?
What's Brown to me? One word. Mahoney. Mahoney does the work of three. So instead of three different guys for ground deliveries, overnight, and international.
Hey, how you doing?
And three different pickup times, all I need is one Mahoney and one pickup. You wore the shorts for TV, didn't you?
Put him in. One driver, one pickup, one reliable network. UPS, what can Brown do for you?
Hey, Lisa, fill you up?
Oui, merci beaucoup. Ça serait très bien.
What'll it be, girls?
Deux œufs avec de jambon.
Et aussi un bout de pain.
Two eggs and ham, Jimmy.
With the new American Express card, the things you buy every day can earn you double points with no expiration dates for incredible rewards.
I'm guessing we're in Paris by springtime.
Bonjour, world!
If they're into music, go to the one place that has it all. There's something fun for everyone at Best Buy.
Thank you!
2 minutes left. And we look at the game summary. Mike Vick with only 15 yards on the ground after racking up 173 to set an NFL record in Minnesota last week. Has thrown for a touchdown. Brad Johnson, 4 touchdowns, no interception. Last 4 games has 15 touchdowns, 1 interception. That's how well he's playing. Jurevicius ties his career high with 8 catches in this game. And Derek Brooks with 10 tackles. Buccaneers have been going up and down the field on this Atlanta defense. 3rd down and 7. And they give King a chance to throw it. Now he'll try and run it and slide short of a first down. Now mark him at the 40.
Well, Brad Johnson certainly has been the show today, but I still think that Michael Vick is still an MVP candidate. And the reason why is that probably more of what Bob Whitfield said to us last night. We asked him about, you know, anybody ever get jealous of all the attention Mike Vick gets? He said, are you kidding me? He said, it's Mike Vick and then 10 blue-collar guys who are trying to hang on in the National Football League. What he has done with this franchise to elevate them to a position where they're probably going to make the playoffs is one thing, but what he's done to the city of Atlanta, they're selling tickets that they simply could not sell until Michael Vick got there. There's a real excitement, and yes, he's played poorly in this one today, but he's played against the best defense in football, and a lot of guys have played poorly.
Allen Rawson waiting for it inside the 15, and he gets to the 15. That's it. Corey Ivey with a stop. 48-yard punt. Next week, there'll be a lot of eyes on the late game. Certainly, quite a few will tune in to the Seahawks and Falcons, and we'll see how the Falcons respond to what is a loss here in Tampa, Florida, it would appear. And Packers and 49ers will wrap up the doubleheader, and a big one for NFC playoff seeding. Coverage begins at noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific, next week on Fox. And by the way, Dallas right now out in front of San Francisco, but 9:37 remaining in that game at Texas Stadium. This Tampa defense just does not give up points. Lowest in the NFL. They've allowed 10 today. That's Finneran. Brought down immediately. Today's game being produced by Richie Zients, directed by Artie Kempner, the technical producer Dave Hill, technical director Rich Basile, and the audio mixer Fred Aldis. Steve Horn assisting us up here in the booth. The associate directors are Marcy Kempner and Derek Manning. The broadcast associates Jake Ullman and Jeremy Green. Pre-game show produced by Scott Ackerson, directed by Bob Levy. The associate director is Jennifer Love. Studio technical supervisor Jack Simmons. Senior producer of Fox Sports, Bill Brown. And the executive producers, Ed Gorn and David Hill. TJ Duckett just adds to his stats, gets it up to the 20. And that's going to be it for our day here in Tampa, Florida. The Atlanta Falcons suffer their first loss since October 6th. A 20-6 defeat at the hands of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, who get them again. The defense, Brad Johnson, all big days for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. We'll come back, have a final word after this.
Today to the Mercedes-Benz year-end celebration, offering more models than ever. Going on now at your Mercedes-Benz dealer.
You know that I love my chilies, chilies with spice. They're so nice.
There's a place where the flame-grilled ribeye is seasoned with garlic and herbs, where the new mashed potatoes are loaded with aged cheddar and crisp bacon, and where everything has a little more spice. Want more flavor? Come to Chili's.
Can I take your order?
Give me 15 cheeseburgers.
Come on. Can I take your order?
Can I take your number?
Can I take your order?
You got any eggs?
Can I take your order?
Man, I don't have any money.
I don't have any money.
All right, well, now, hey, go, go.
Man, watch out!
New tackles, one stifling defense. NFL Game Day 2003.
Rated E for everyone.
I am the Black & Decker cordless multi-tool. I'm a loner. I am three tools in one. If I have something to cut, I'm a saw. If I have some sanding to do, bam, sander. And if I feel like drilling, well, then guess what? People tell me my lifestyle is a recipe for loneliness. Table for one, please. I am the multi-tool from Black & Decker.
Now with Cirque Saw and router attachments. Available in kits of three or five.
Don't miss appearances by Rod Stewart, Cher, Michael Jackson, and more. Live at the 2002 Billboard Music Awards at 8, 7 Central, Fox Monday.
Dunkin' Donuts coffee by the pound. Just the thing to enjoy at home.
What could be more important than that? Get 2 pounds of any flavor coffee for just $8.99. Available in-store and online. Just the thing to brew at home.
It only happens once a year. Toyotathon 03. This year-end tradition features incredible values on your favorite Toyota cars. See your Toyota dealer now for great year-end deals on Camry. Like financing as low as 0.0% APR on all 2003 Camry models. Or lease a 2003 Camry LE for $239 a month for 39 months with $1,738 due at signing. Toyotathon 03. Don't miss it. See your Toyota dealer today.
Stay tuned for Chip Carter's Bucs post-game show with highlights, interviews, and expert analysis of today's game. That's all coming up next on Fox 13.
John Gruden, the head coach of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, should have a smile on his face, a grin from ear to ear after this one, a 34-10 final. Our UPS leaderboard, UPS delivers a chance for you to win a big screen TV. To watch the big game, just log on to foxsports.com. What a day for Brad Johnson. The running game was here. Joe Juravicius, a big day through the air. We knew the defense, how they like to play, but how about the offensive line, the running game, the play of Brad Johnson? Come on, John Gruden, smile. JB and the gang, coming up. There we go.